Tour 2012. Love it doesn't get any better than this. July 31st, Oak Mountain Amphitheater. Two iconic bands. One historic tour. Kiss. Motley Crue. July 31st, Oak Mountain Amphitheater. Reserve seats are on sale now. Buy tickets at LiveNation.com or charge by phone at 800-745-3000. Kiss and Motley Crue. Buy tickets at LiveNation.com.
It's a quarter after one.
Open the night with Lady Annabella. And Darius Rucker.
So this is not my bed. Come back.
June 21st at Oak Mountain Amphitheater.
Just a kiss on your lips in the moonlight.
Lady Annabella, on the night, 2012 so World bright. Tour.
Baby, you're the only one I run to.
Lady Annabella Live.
I run to you.
And Darius Rucker.
It won't be like this for long.
Plus, special guest, Thompson Square.
You gonna kiss me or not?
June 21st at Oak Mountain Amphitheater. Get reserved seats now at LiveNation.com or charge by phone.
Hey, I'm just looking for
Don't miss Lady Annabella and Darius Rucker with special guest Thompson Square.
Yeah,
sponsored by GAC. Buy tickets at LiveNation.com.
When planning your next party or special event, insist on the best. Four Range Entertainment is a professional entertainment company providing a full range of services. From professional disc jockeys and MCs to catering and photography, when the details of your special day must be perfect, call us first. Wedding receptions, corporate parties, school functions, birthday celebrations, and more. We also have Birmingham's largest selection of karaoke tracks available. With over 40 years combined experience, Four Range Entertainment can provide you with the talent and professionalism you need and deserve to make your next event one you'll never forget. For more information on the full range of services we offer, call 533-HITS, that's 533-HITS, or check us out on our website at fullrangeentertainment.com.
This is Dale the Demon Torborg.
My name is Bryce Rensburg. I'm the Chikara Senior Official.
This is April Hunter from AprilHunter.com.
I'm Bobby Chez, the three-time world champion, Showtime Expert Analyst.
This Coolio with the Flow, a.k.a. the Ghetto Gourmet.
This is Dan the B7, the only Triple Crown champion in the UFC history.
Hi, everybody. This is Jerry the King Lawler. That's right. WWE Hall of Famer.
This is Jeff Damon from Deadliest Wear on Spike TV.
You have tuned in and are now live listening to the three-time NWA Heavyweight Champion of the World, Scrapper Ann Pierce. And just like you, I am also locked in. And, brother, we are beyond ringside.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, lift off.
Like to say greetings, good evening, and how the hell are you? Live from the Full Range Entertainment Studios in beautiful Birmingham, Alabama, hiding in the vault. And unlike the Easter eggs, you can't find me today. Good luck with that. Welcome into your home for wrestling, mixed martial arts, sports talk, and a whole bunch more. I think I'm still feeling the effects of the sleeper from last night. This is Beyond Ringside. Fast Eddie Lane in the control center. Welcoming in tag team partners, Mark Mabo Bowman.
Yeah.
He's unconscious as well. Did Micah get you?
No. My
roommate was awesome enough to... We had a special at Target, was buy two $59.99 games and get like a third one free, and out of the goodness of his heart, he is free when he chose to be WWE 12, so I've been playing that for like about a week.
Ooh, very nice.
Yeah, so I'm over here customizing and doing this, that, and the other.
About 5'10", 260 pounds, long brownish hair.
Me or the chick?
Are you customizing your wrestling? Oh, you're wrestling. You're doing customizing a diva. Never mind.
Actually, no. I'm just playing through the universe mode, and it's fun. So anyway,
like to welcome in tag team partner, the Oracle of Ominous, the Wicked Nemesis.
You know, gentlemen, there's some weekends where domination is the key word. I believe that this weekend was the personification of domination on my behalf. Let me just say right off the bat what a great honor it was to hand the ACW Southern Women's Championship to your first ever champion, calm like a bomb, Pandora. It was a hard-fought victory, but the better woman came out on top. And it was wow. I mean, it was an amazing weekend. I know we've all had, you know, those weekends, but this was the one. This was Pandora's first, and I know this is going to sound messed up, first ever championship for Pandora. Can you believe that?
Very nice.
11 years in the business, first championship ever.
Very nice. A great honor. Congratulations goes out to Pandora. Speaking of champions, we are going to have the winner of the 2012 Carnage Cup from IWA Deep South. Spider Boudreaux is going to be joining us in just about 10 minutes right here on Beyond Ringside. And a little bit later on the evening, we have actually got another interview planned, but the situation's in place. I'm going to hold off on that. Our favorite MMA reporter, Vicky Jackson, is going to be joining us just after the top of the 7 o'clock Central Time hour. And it's been hectic all the way across the board. Let me go and lay this one out there. Last night, Global Championship Wrestling, the Underground showed it all over again. And for those of you over in our chat room right now, I'll just go ahead and pull up the graphic. And I'll give you the short version of the story. Over the last couple of weeks, Micah Taylor, GCW Heavyweight Champion and the leader of the Underground, and I have been going back and forth. A little lighthearted picking back and forth with each other. And I guess last night, Micah decided he wanted to take things to the next level as far as taking it to in-ring physicality, which I'm not... It's been over a decade and a half since I've been in the ring. And last night, Micah, when I just basically said, I'm going to have nothing to do with it and tried to walk out, Micah sneaks up, not really sneaks, he just basically bulls his way up behind me and throws me straight into a sleeper hold. And does not stop until I'm out. And I'm sorry, with all due respect, the sleeper hold that he was putting on me was not just a standard sleeper that's going to cut off the blood flow through the carotid artery. That was a choke. I was having a difficult time breathing. And for those of you looking at the screen right now, the other figure in the background on the right-hand side in front of the logo is actually Spiral, also part of the Underground. To my knowledge, he did not physically interject himself. I believe he was there basically to keep Micah in check, to make sure Micah didn't go any more overboard or over the line than he did. From that vantage point on this particular screenshot, you can see, and this was from the cam that we had set up on the table with the broadcast position. Yes, that is me laid out on the floor after the effects of the sleeper. Micah Taylor standing tall, if you will, along with Spiral. So I'm going to be addressing a lot of that a little bit later on this evening, not necessarily here on Beyond Ringside. I'll be coming back personally on a different broadcast at 9 o'clock p.m. Central Standard or Central Daylight Time. But a couple of things I want to hear real quick. And before I go anywhere, Mabo, have not had a chance to get your feedback off WrestleMania. Any thoughts you'd like to lay out there?
Hold on, dude. I want you to... Back up, doing throw them graphics up again. I'm just like, I just flipped over. I want to see it. Put the graphics back up.
I'll put the graphics back up. This the first one coming up is actually when Micah came in from behind and got me with the sleeper. The second one coming up is going to be the after effect, me laid out on the canvas. And from that vantage point, yeah. So in successive order, so to speak, Mad Dog Dan Sawyer has fallen victim to the Underground. Amos Moses, the Inhuman Fly, Jeremy Foster, last night, Cody O'Connor, valiant effort. And also in the middle of last night, yours truly. So there's a lot of questions to be answered. I've been hit with nonstop questions all day long. My phone was a pinball machine this morning. People asking, what are you going to do? Well, I'll address that on a different show later tonight. GCW Radio will be airing at 9 o'clock p.m. Central Daylight Time. So I'll address those questions there, not here. So after everything's said and done here, join me at 9 o'clock over there. Now, you've had a chance to see it, Mabo, WrestleMania.
Nah, dude, that first one, man, that looked like a little bit of pee on the front of your pants, dude.
Not even close, Junior.
You got a bunch of sleeper. You look at that. You peed your pants. Everything, you peed in your pants. What do you got put out? And by a guy with a crappy haircut. Dang.
And for the record, peeing in the pants is the same thing you do anytime you try to talk to a member of the female sex. But
Meanwhile,
yeah, but they're usually like 300 pounds and trying to, you know, cut in line at the buffet. So
yeah.
You know, you gotta kind of
did
watch
not
out like that.
Did not happen, Mark.
Okay, Maria Menounos. Anyway,
okay, Kelly Kelly.
Damn, if I was Kelly Kelly, I wouldn't be talking to y'all right now. I'd be diddling my DJ Skittles, if you know what I'm saying.
Anyway, continue.
I'm trying, but you just got to get the last word, because you're Eddie Lane.
You always got to get the last word in.
All right, P-Fans. Anyway, Mania.
Okay, Cake Fart.
Hey, dude, that's an awesome video. Look it up. Cake Fart! Mania. Not, well, you know, first of all, I didn't like how the world heavyweight?
Yeah, 18 seconds.
Yeah, is that the big gold belt? Is the world heavyweight? Yeah, didn't like how that was handled. Made the title look like crap. Made Daniel Bryan, you know, who is a phenomenal wrestler. Yeah, he's a little bit smaller than Sheamus, but come on, man, it made him look like crap. And, but I, being spun out of this, you know, he's getting a new shirt. And, I don't know. I don't know where they're going to go from there with this, but I personally think it was, you know, bullcrap. Apparently all the crowds, you know, the crowds over the past two or three shows have thought it was bullcrap. But you got to realize something. As crappy as it was and as much as it tarnished the belt and really both guys, I'm gonna say both guys, the payoff they got is probably nothing to sneeze at, so.
Nope.
You know, just overall, I thought it was like my two favorite was Jericho Punk and Taker Triple H. I thought those both told very, very, very good stories. Surprised by the ending of The Rock Cena. Really surprised. I don't think really anybody saw it coming because I think we all picked Cena in our predictions.
Yeah,
because
pretty
much. It's like we all said, you know. It doesn't really benefit The Rock to win because he's just going to disappear like he's done. You know, he showed up Monday night. I guarantee you, The Rock's going to, he's got a dream, he's got a vision, going to win the belt, and he's gone. So, hopefully, you know, whatever this payoff is, if the payoff's what I think the payoff's going to be, you know, it's going to work. But, I mean, overall, I thought it was a good WrestleMania. It's not been the greatest. Yeah, and for the record, I did go back and look. The stain appeared right after Maria Menounos gave the stink face to Eve, so it was makeup and not poop. And I was really hoping it was poop, because I was going to get on her Twitter and laugh at her, because she pooped her pants. But yeah, I thought it was good. It's not one of the greatest, but it was overall, I'd give it out of a 10, I'd give it about a 7.5 to 8.
I think really you're concurrent with what a lot of people are saying now. I think one of the advantages of this WrestleMania and Wicked, I'm going to ask you your opinion on this one. Remembering last year, now, going into Mania last year, Dwayne was the guest host of WrestleMania in Atlanta. And this year he was actually more talent than anything else, if you can use the word rock and talent in the same sentence. Do you think we actually benefited from not having a guest host of WrestleMania this year as opposed to last year when it was the cheesiest cornball intro for Dwayne that I've ever heard of anybody done in my life, Wicked Nemesis?
Well, we talked about this last year, you know, leading up to that WrestleMania on this very show. They were pushing young talent last year. They've also started pushing young talent this year. The guest host was just, obviously, as we know, to get over Rock, to get Rock ready for this WrestleMania. As you and I discussed on this very think tank on PW 24/7 Radio right after WrestleMania.
Yep.
I believe personally that this WrestleMania was better than last WrestleMania.
Ditto.
This was definitely a 4 out of 5 WrestleMania, and not only that, I believe that they did something that they didn't think that they or they ever thought about doing, and the Sheamus Daniel Bryan squash made Daniel Bryan now a cult icon. I believe now he is a cult figure, and for the rest of his career and probably for the rest of our lives and generations to come, yes will be echoed off the walls for everywhere.
Like it was in the American era.
And it was great, because Monday night, that overshadowed Rock.
Yeah.
Yes, has overshadowed Brock. I mean, yes, yes, he has overshadowed everything. It was in every match, and immediately after the Daniel Bryan Sheamus match, they started chanting, Daniel Bryan. It's kind of the fuck you. Oops, sorry. Sorry. It's kind of the big finger to Vince for the simple fact that Vince wanted. We know this. We talked about this. There was no kayfabe to it. They didn't want Daniel Bryan to have this title. Am I correct? They didn't want him going with this title leading into WrestleMania, right?
Yeah, pretty much.
We kept hearing stories come out, this angle, to get the belt off Daniel Bryan. And then what happens? Daniel Bryan is talked about the rest of the night after he loses in 18 seconds. Monday night, it was everywhere. Even John Cena acknowledged it. I think that they didn't want this to happen, but it has happened. Daniel Bryan is over now more than anybody in WWE, with the exception of CM Punk and maybe Brock Lesnar now since his return.
Now, if I may, noting the fact of how John Cena handled the Daniel Bryan chants and the yes, yes, yes chants, and made the statement point blank, Daniel Bryan, you owe me one, when he acknowledged it, wouldn't it, I mean, to me, that actually kind of cheapened Cena. And, you know, yeah, he's the flag bearer for the company. Yes, he's the poster child, all of the above. But I think that he could have chosen a better phrase than, you owe me one.
You know, as soon as he said that, the crowd started cheering. Like, acknowledge it, yay, you know, because the fact that the face of your company is acknowledging the yes, yes, yes chant shows that they're not deaf. You know, I think a lot of people believe that when you get in the ring, you need to drown out with the, or some people do. A lot of Bishop says he can't hear the crowd at all when he's in the ring. Certain people like that, but we have the face of the company talking about a guy that just got squashed the night before. I believe that this is something that they didn't expect to happen, but it happened. And CCC. What about the Alberto Del Rio CCC chance?
That that was hilarious as hell. Maybo, did you catch that?
Oh, yeah. Like I said, it was. The whole thing was just is phenomenal. And I don't think it cheapened Cena to sit there and go, Daniel Bryan, you owe me one. Because, I mean, it was just Cena. It was, if anything, it was more like Cena saying, hey, you know, Vince, hey.
Yeah.
Front office. This is the truth. I mean, you know, Cena's always been one to help, you know, guys who deserve to be at the forefront, you know, like he did with Zack Ryder and a couple other guys. You know, he's not, you know, that's the one thing is when Cena genuinely gets behind something, he didn't wait for it to get hot and then jump on it. Cena will sit there and point it out and go, hey, look at this. Let's work with this. You know, I don't necessarily have to work with it, but let's bring it up to the forefront. Let's listen to the fans. You know, matter if they're booing or cheering him. And if you go and you can probably YouTube it, unless WWE's taking it down right now, right after after Raw ended, there was a dark match, and it involved Daniel Bryan, and he actually goes out there and he addresses everything. He, you know, he genuinely thanks the fans. I mean, this is not like the, you know, what you saw on SmackDown. It's like, oh, you're mocking me, blah, blah, blah. He genuinely thanks the fans. The fans are cheering him. He's like, hey, you know, because of this yes, yes, yes deal, you know, now WWE's got to give me a new shirt. And they did. He said this Monday night, and I think it was by Thursday or yesterday, the shirt's already up and should be available at WWEshop.com. So, I mean, you know, and it was just hilarious. Even when he mockingly told AJ to get out of the ring Monday night, everybody was like just chanting yes, yes, yes. And it's gotten, yes, yes, yes has grown so popular so quickly, somebody at Stone Cold said, well, what do you think about yes, 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 or yes replacing what? And he's like, love it, go with it. So, there you go.
Sounds like a, I just don't particularly care for the way that he acknowledged it. He could have done something slightly different. But that's just my opinion, and that $2.25 can actually get you a cup of coffee at Waffle House before tip. End of discussion. Tell you what, let's go and go to a break real quick. We're going to reset everything around the studio, and I do believe that unless something has changed, we're going to be joined by the winner of Carnage Cup 8, Spider Boudreaux, right here on Beyond Ringside, right after this.
Hey, everyone. My name is Bryce Rensburg. I'm the Chikara Senior Official. And wherever I am in the world, be it on the phone or the internet, there's no place I'd rather be than locked in to Beyond Ringside.
8. I deliver your Sunday paper every week.
7. We work on the same floor.
1 in 8 Americans is struggling with hunger.
6. Our kids walk to school together every day.
including millions of children and seniors.
5. We chat in the elevator at work sometimes.
4. I'm your cashier at the grocery store.
Who's the 1 in 8 in your life that needs help? You can make a difference through Feeding America at feedingamerica.org/1in8. A public service announcement brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
Yo, what's up? It's Coolio with the Flow, a.k.a. the Ghetto Gourmet, and you locked in to Beyond Ringside. Ding, ding.
It's a quarter after one.
Own the night with Lady Annabella. And Darius Rucker.
So this is not my bed. Come back. So.
June 21st at Oak Mountain Amphitheater.
Just a kiss on your lips in the moonlight.
Lady Annabella, Own the Night, 2012 so World bright. Tour.
Baby, you're the only one I run to.
Lady Annabella Live.
I run to you.
And Darius Rucker.
It won't be like this for long.
Plus, special guest, Thompson Square.
You gonna kiss me or not?
June 21st at Oak Mountain Amphitheater. Get reserved seats now at LiveNation.com or charge by phone.
Hey, I'm just looking for
Don't miss Lady Annabella and Darius Rucker with special guest Thompson Square.
Yeah,
sponsored by GAC. Buy tickets at LiveNation.com.
Most days go by without a whole lot of surprises. But what if a disaster strikes without warning? What if life as you know it has completely turned on its head? Would you be prepared? Before a disaster turns your family's world upside down, be ready. Get a kit. Make a plan. Be informed. Learn how at www.ready.gov. Brought to you by the Federal Emergency Management Agency and the Ad Council.
Hello, everybody. This is Dirty Dutch Mantel, and you're locked in to Beyond Ringside.
The odds of becoming a signed artist and having 3 number one albums? 1 in 100 million. The odds of going on to win 6 Grammy Awards? 1 in 1.4 million. The odds of this performer having a child diagnosed with autism? 1 in 110. I'm Toni Braxton, and I encourage you to learn the signs of autism at autismspeaks.org. Autism Speaks. It's time to listen. Brought to you by Autism Speaks and the Ad Council.
This is Ben Masters, locking it down with Beyond Ringside. Don't miss it. Be there.
Hi, I'm Ryan Seacrest for RAD. Over 300 people in this country are killed every week by a drunk driver. That's the equivalent of 2 747 plane crashes every single week. And the problem isn't going away unless we all do our part to stop it. So if you see someone who's about to drive after drinking, get the keys. Don't leave it up to anyone else. Friends don't let friends drive drunk.
A public service announcement brought to you by RAD, the National Association of Broadcasters, and the Ad Council.
This is Bob Allen, co-author of Gordon Solie, Something Left Behind and the Solie Chronicles, and I'm locked into Beyond Ringside.
The biggest bands in rock, the wildest stage shows on earth. The biggest live event of the summer.
Everybody's gonna move their feet.
Yes. And Motley Crue.
Yeah. Kings got a heart, hope it never stops.
The Tour 2012.
Love
it doesn't get any better than this. July 31st, Oak Mountain Amphitheater. Two iconic bands, one historic tour. Kiss, Motley Crue.
Girls, girls, girls.
July 31st, Oak Mountain Amphitheater. Reserve seats are on sale now. Buy tickets at LiveNation.com or charge by phone at 800-745-3000. Kiss and Motley Crue. Buy tickets at LiveNation.com.
Hi, this is Ozzy Osbourne. For many years, you know I've had a drink problem and I'm trying to battle that problem every single day. But one thing I don't do, I don't drive my car when I'm drinking. I get someone to drive me. Do not drink and drive. It's the stupidest thing. If you drink, just don't drive. Not only are you going to hurt yourself, you may hurt some other person, and you wouldn't want that on your conscience, would you?
A public service announcement brought to you by the U.S. Department of Transportation, RAD, the National Association of Broadcasters, and the Ad Council.
This is Dan the B7, the only Triple Crown champion in the UFC history, and you're listening to Beyond Ringside. You better pay attention, otherwise, I know where you live.
And welcome back in on this Sunday night kind of thing. 26 after the hour. We're going to go ahead and take our bottom of the hour break a little bit early, so we're going to go ahead and slide right on back into things. Fast Eddie Lane behind the control panel. Wicked Nemesis, come on back in.
Ow!
Mabo, what up?
You know what I'm talking about? We're going to take the bottom and slide it in. Go get it up there, girl. Go spit on it and ow, slide it in.
I thought you were going to say smack it, flip it, rub it up, down. Oh, no, look at that booty. Okay.
Ooh.
And I know, there are some things that I should just never say. word. I'll listen to that on playback and go, holy crap, did I actually just say that? You know.
Yes, you did, white boy.
There you go.
Ow!
Excuse me, dude, I ain't cracker. I'm Italian. There's a difference there, aight?
Nah.
Yeah,
I'm not saltine.
Yeah, wrong. If I'm saltine, that would definitely make you unsalted and half-baked while you're at it. Mm.
Damn right, son. I'm going to shag me a bucket of fried chicken. Woo!
Thought you were going to say a baked potato for a second there. However,
I found somebody better.
David Elder from Strike Hard Productions is going to be joining us at the top of the 7 o'clock hour. They've got an event coming up in the very near future. Also, MMA reporter Vicky Jackson, our favorite mixed martial arts reporter, will be on board with us. It's been a very eventful week. It really has. And
Eddie, I would like to speak about something really quick if I can.
Yes, you may.
Friday night NWA Pro South. As many of you know, I've been dabbling in the art of fire as of recently. trying to throw fireballs.
No, Mabo, he didn't say set fire to his balls. He said throw fireballs.
Listen to this. So Friday night, Caden, whatever. I know I'm going to break Caden's fade, but who really gives a crap? I just dropped the F-bomb on the freaking radio show. Sorry, Eddie.
It's okay.
So I told him that the whole thing was that the judge that I'm managing at Pro South was supposed to be there, and the judge couldn't make it. And so the whole thing was, you know, what was supposed to happen, the lights come on. In theory, it was awesome. Lights come on. I'm sitting in a chair that's already open. I've got my head hung low. I'm cutting my promo. The two guys that just got beat up by Daniel Alexander and Toom, NWA Pro Style Tag Team Champions, and one was supposed to have a noose around his neck, and another was supposed to be, you know, kind of just knocked out, obviously. So, found out that the judge, that the noose isn't there. The judge actually has a noose on vacation with him. I kid you not.
Really?
So, okay, well, this is what we'll do. You know, I've been doing fireballs. I have one of the, you know, one of the guys, Caden, whatever his name is, caught a fireball. You know, he's supposed to, you know, stand up, and I was like, hold on for a second, finish my, you know, stop my promo, throw the fireball at him, you know, blind him, and then sit right down. In theory, that's awesome. If this was WWE, oh, it'd been great. It'd been great. Unfortunately, this is the Indies. The lights come on. The lights come on, and then when I'm like almost in the chair, so there's this awkward moment where I've got like one knee down, like I'm getting ready to propose to the chair. I'm just trying to push the chair, like, oh, that's kind of promo. The Caden kid had already started to kind of come to his feet a little bit, you know. And I got on the mic, I said, hold on for a second, set my mask down. As I go to take the fireball to throw it, I got to take a step back to make sure I do not hit this kid in the face. How about I throw it and the fireball explodes in my hands? Ooh. Notes to me at the time, I feel like my index finger and my middle finger are on fire. What I was told is upstairs on the monitor, you could see that my two fingers had flames coming out of them. The flash paper had actually stuck to my fingertips. I get to the back and Caden asked me, dude, did you hit me with a flaming fist? My two fingers are on fire, and I actually hit a gentleman with a flaming fist Friday night. That is the first for me. And I think I should have said, flaming uppercut, but I didn't. I missed that Dolphin, that moment. I missed that.
I mean, seriously, dude, you had the perfect Street Fighter moment.
Oh, I know, Mabo. I know.
You could have won Hadouken!
Did anybody get a picture of this or a video, Wick?
Yes, it is video.
It is video. I want to see this damn video.
I have to get it. I have to get the footage. I have been in contact with the gentleman that filmed, Safety Sam. I said, dude, you've got to get me that. And he said, and he does believe that from his angle, which is on the roving cam, that you can see it. Caden saw it. Everyone upstairs saw it on the monitors. But, you know, NWA Pro's house, literally backstage, you know, some places don't even have one monitor. Or they don't have one crappy monitor that's like a black and white, you know, like a Mac 1982 spinach green color, if you're lucky. But no, they had five monitors. Five. They even had the old ladder point of view from up above, to where somebody, you know, trying to reach something off the ladder, you can actually see them unbuckle it, which I love that. One of my favorite angles. But this footage, as soon as I get it, will be up.
Dude, you totally got to tag. At least tag me and Beyond Ringside and Facebook and Twitter when you put that up so I can see it.
Yes, I will. My two fingers, my index and my middle finger on my right hand have flames on them as I punch this guy in the face.
And a number of people know that one of my favorite sportscasters of all time is Dan Patrick. And to this point, I'm sure that somewhere right now in Milford, Mr. Patrick would be sitting back going, the wicked nemesis is in fuego.
In fuego.
He is in fuego.
I'm sorry, I tried to time it out with you. I love that. And a biscuit in a basket. See, Dan Patrick and Keith Olbermann were awesome. I love what Jonathan Coachman's doing. I do. Every time I hear Coachman, I'm like, that's one of me. That's one of us. He's all that. You know, he's made it.
Yeah.
But Charlie Steiner was one of the best. I love Charlie Steiner because he used to always laugh. But Olbermann and Patrick, the tisket and the tasket, the flower-making basket, yes, great stuff. And I do regret that I did not do some Street Fighter form of some catchphrase, because God knows I played enough Street Fighter that I should have. And yes, I am hairy like Blanca.
Oh Lord, it's
funny. Right, but I'm repeatedly tapping circle. I'm electrocuting everybody. Can you feel that? Can you feel that at home? I'm electrocuting you.
You got the shoot. Got the tens unit in place, powered by a diesel engine, right?
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry. It's one of those sick freak moments coming out, so I'm going to leave it at that. You know, I'm not going to say sick freak, but speaking of sick moments, I'm actually loving the factor coming out of Showdown in the Sun. Segway, this past weekend, WrestleMania weekend on the 30th and 31st down in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, Davey Richards able to hold on to the championship through two consecutive nights, held on it through the triple threat on the 30th, turned around and held the championship and successfully defended it yet again on the 31st against Unbreakable Michael Elgin. And if you remember the interview we had with Scrap Iron Adam Pearce here on Beyond Ringside recently, on the 29th, remember, NWA Ring Warriors had Battle of the Belts. And this is something we haven't had a chance to cover. We didn't get a chance to cover it last Sunday on BR, but I wanted to definitely get the mention out there for it this time. The mystery hand-picked opponent that Jim Cornette chose to go against Scrap Iron Adam Pearce actually was Adam Cole, which from all indications and from all the feedback that I've gotten over the last week and a half was actually a tremendous match, which with Cole in the ring, yeah, definitely. That's a given on that one, because the kid's got skills. I mean, I wasn't too thrilled about Future Shock and the first time when they were first getting together. I'm referring to him and Kyle O'Reilly. But the fact of the matter is, as they've gotten experience, and this is something that a lot of people have to remember in the world of pro wrestling and sports entertainment. Sometimes experience genuinely is the best teacher, because you can get in the ring on a quiet afternoon with the rest of the locker room, and you can bump it out and you can train and you can work till you've got it down pat. But I don't care who says what, when you get in the ring and you know that cameras are rolling for a nationally televised product or even a local product, the fact of the matter is, you're going to have some nerves. And the fun part about it is, the people watching the product on television or on the internet aren't always going to be your biggest critics. It's those people with whom you train are going to shred you if you mess something up that you know you've gotten right 100 times in practice that you just gave it up because of nerves. Now, I'm just going to go ahead and say, Wicked, would you agree or disagree with that?
They better be. Those are the ones that should be the most honest with you. The people that should be the most brutal, the ones that you trust the most. Everybody knows. Damon Taz. Now, I actually had this conversation with Daniel Alexander in Columbine, I think it was Monday night.
you know, as a vet in the Pro South locker room and at ACW and AWA, I watch as many of the matches as I can. If you don't ask my opinion, I won't give it to you unless you're so blatantly awful that somebody has to step in. But Daniel Alexander and Columbine, Joey Sartain, Chris Knox, Damon Taz, Johnny Slaughter, Orion Bishop, Calm Like a Bomb, Pandora, and now Octavia, as she found out very quickly, I will roast your ass. I will tell you everything you did wrong, but I will also tell you how to correct it. That's the difference between myself and a lot of guys. There's a lot of guys that will tell you just what you did right. There's guys, and you know this, Eddie, you know this, Good World, Mabo, you know this. There are guys that will blow smoke up your butt so quick, and that's all they'll do. They will not tell you anything they'll do wrong. Then you have guys that will tell you everything you did wrong, but won't tell you how to correct it.
Right.
For all the vets out there, you should step up and tell somebody what they did wrong when they ask you, and you should be able to immediately tell them how to correct it.
Yeah.
Psychology is lost in this business. Your trainer, and your best friends, especially a tag team partner or a manager of my behalf, should be the ones that are the most brutal. And give it up to Davey Richards. This has got to be Davey. He had a strong last year and just picking straight back up this year with it. Kudos to him.
Now, let me shift topics for a second. Let me keep the same topic for a different example. Mabo. I say that people behind the scenes are the biggest critics and the worst critics, but when you have fans of this business who have been such passionate fans for as long as people like you and Tunzi, Brooks Logan, Josh Hand, Clay Burton, some of the heel section from over in the AWF fan page, you guys think about it is you'll shred somebody during a match, but I've noticed that it's like positive critiquing or positive criticism. It's constructive criticism in the shredding. Now, therein lies the funny part. Because you and Tunzi especially will lay it out there in such a way that it's going to be humorous. It's going to be funny. But it's also going to be spot on perfect. Now, the reason I lay it out there like that is people like you and Tunzi Brooks and the rest of the cast aren't necessarily the typical fans. Do you think that... There's a question in my head that I'm trying to form, and why do you think that y'all approach the way that you, approach things the way that y'all do?
Mainly because we're a-holes and we just want to piss people off.
Oh, okay.
It's like this. If you remember the old ECW crowd or what's known as the Northeast crowd, you know,
Philly bunch.
Yeah, I look at it like this. I mean, I can't speak for every one of them because I'm not in their heads. I don't know what they're thinking when they do these chants. Same thing, I can't speak for Tunzi or Brooks or any of the what do they call the heel club, heel section. Whatever. Personally, if I rarely do it. Now, I mean, if it's somebody I know, like you, or Wicked, or Blur Hagen, you know, somebody who I know, I just do it as a good-natured rib, although, let's be honest, Wicked Nemesis has never made any mistakes. He even took a botched fireball and turned it into a Street Fighter-like move.
Yeah.
So, you know, I know it's been a year, but winning! Okay, there we go. But I look at it like this. If we know the guy is green, if he's a rookie, and, you know, when we do say stuff, it's like letting them know, hey, kid, you know, you obviously haven't trained long enough. Think about what you're doing. Slow it down. You know, don't rush it. You know, build a story. And on the flip side, it's like, you know, with somebody who's been in the business for a while, you know, we respect them, but at the same time, it's like, dude, you know better. You've done this. We've sit there and, you know, watched you do this time after time after time. And you know, look what happened. I mean, I know everybody makes a mistake, but if you've been in the business for X number of years, and I've seen, if it's something as simple as, you know, coming off top rope or whatever, and you botched that, not because it was a slip. I mean, you could tell when, you know, the turnbuckle got sweaty and you slip.
Right.
Difference when it slip and then you just screwed up your own move that you know, that it would be like Austin screwing up a stunner.
Right.
How many times over the years have we seen Austin hit a stunner? Picture perfect every time.
Not every time.
Well, you know what I'm saying. It's just, but it's like, you know, you see that. We're also letting you know, hey, you screwed up, get back on your game, or we will treat you just like we treat, you know, anybody else in the business. We respect you, but at the same time, don't get too big for your britches, so to speak. And speaking of, you were talking about Adam Cole and, you know, the tremendous match he had with Scrap Iron Adam Pearce. It also speaks volumes that he was one of the final two. If anybody caught Ring of Honor TV this weekend,
yep.
You know, he was one of the final two in their, you know, March Madness deal against Tommaso Ciampa, Jay Lethal, and I believe wasn't it
Roderick Kyle Strong,
his tag team partner?
Roderick Strong.
Roderick was Strong? No, Strong wasn't in it, was it?
I thought.
No, I'm talking about in the actual Fatal Four Way.
Okay.
I'm talking about I'm talking about the finals that were on TV last night.
Okay.
I want to say it was Kyle O'Reilly. Anyway, spoiler, if you didn't watch it last night, you're going to watch it tonight. O'Reilly went out first, and then Lethal, the veteran of the four, he got put out by Tommaso Ciampa. And then that final moments between Ciampa and Adam Cole were just amazing. And you really thought, you know, holy crap, Adam Cole, a guy who started out, I'm not going to say jobber, but he was definitely curtain jerking on the TV show in a tag team.
Right.
Is moments away from winning this quote-unquote $25,000. So, you know, of course, Ciampa won, and I would not be surprised if WWE knocks on his door in the next year or so. But, you know, to go to the final two with Adam Cole, that speaks volumes.
18 before the top of the hour here on Beyond Ringside. Fast Eddie Lane, Mark Mabo Bowman, the Oracle of Ominous, the Wicked Nemesis on the Sunday night's main event. Originally scheduled to be joined by Carnage Cup 8 winner Spider Boudreaux at this time. Unfortunately, we have not been able to get the communications line straightened out. We are going to be joined by David Elder from Strike Hard Productions in just a little while. Right here on Beyond Ringside. Also, we will be going back to our regular start time of 5:30 p.m. Next Sunday night on the 15th. Now, making a segue real quick.
Hold on, Eddie.
Yes.
I know how we can get in touch with Spidar.
Okay.
Has anybody thought about checking the web?
Oh, God. That was actually so horrible. Thanks. It was funny. Thank you, Mabo. Now, there's something that I want to bring up, and I'm going to put it to both of y'all. Noting what has happened with WWE over the last 6 months... And go to NXT before you answer. I mean, for those listening, check out NXT on WWE.com, as well as check out Superstars through WWE.com. You'll see a complete oxymoron in play from what you're seeing on Raw and SmackDown. Keeping things in context, and by the way, before I go any further, and I'm surprised Mabo has not jumped on this yet, this past Thursday night, Impact, welcome back Chris Sabin to national television, welcome back to the Motor City Machine Guns, they looked absolutely crisp and incredible all over again.
Way to blow it, Eddie. I was going to make that a whole freaking segment after the, that was going to be the next thing I texted you, but you just had to go and spoil it, so.
I'm going to get your input on it. I want your input on it. However, the point that I'm getting to is, especially when it comes to the Machine Guns, because a lot of us on this show heralded the MCMG as part of that, even though they'd both been around TNA for a while, as part of that youth movement and that new blood in a sorely needing tag team division in TNA, and now more than ever, even though the Guns are a more established tag team now than they were then. I look personally at Ring of Honor as far as nationally televised products go. NXT doesn't count because it's dot-commed. Same thing with Superstars. As the youth movement in professional wrestling and sports entertainment. Because you've got some bright young stars who are honing their craft, developing their skills, continuing to improve and getting better and better by the week. Every outing that they have, they continue to improve. And By the way, who was the new guy who debuted on SmackDown this past Friday night? Did either of y'all catch that? I didn't catch his name.
That is Ryback. That was Skip Sheffield.
Oh, I knew he looked familiar. I just didn't think that was him.
Well, that's why I sent you that text about let's talk about the new people coming in.
That's why I was going.
There's two things that happen this time of year right after Mania. The draft and the firings.
Yeah, the new blood being brought up. The younger generation being given a shot. Also, if y'all both checked your email, you'll see a link to FCW's broadcast this week.
Oh, is that what it is? I saw the. I hadn't looked. I didn't get to the link, though. I hadn't watched the FCW. I did read the spoiler, though. But, like you said, you asked who that was. That was Ryback, of course, part of this, new youth movement and bringing in people. But I hate to tell you this, dude. More than likely, the guys you see on NXT and those that are showing up as superstars, along with a couple of the lower and mid-card guys, might not be around, come April or May.
Very true.
Because it's always house cleaning. I know WWE's chomping at the bit to bring up, Dean Ambrose, a.k.a. Jon Moxley, who had a bit go on with Mick Foley, I believe right before the Hall of Fame, where he came up to Mick and basically, told Mick that Mick should be in jail for ruining lives of, 14-year-old boys across, the world. And I was like, whoa, where are we going with this? I thought that was mainly Catholic priests that did that. But, and then I guess, Mick kept saying, well, what are you getting at? Did I kill one of your friends or, are we responsible? What's your name? And, Dean was hurried off. So they're chomping at the bit to bring him up. And, of course, Claudio and Tyler Black and Chris Hero and several others are looking to be brought up. So expect to hear FCW firings, I would say, in the next 2 to 3 weeks, and then full roster firings. JTG will probably be gone. So, I mean, I don't know.
Now, have either of you heard anything about the draft? I haven't heard yet.
Wick, you heard anything?
No, sir, not yet. I hope they don't have it.
Well, I know they're going to have it. I'm just trying to remember when and where I heard. Let me pull up. Let me contact Oracle and see what they say.
Now, Wicked Nemesis, would you agree or disagree? While Mabo's looking that up, Wicked, would you agree or disagree that a company such as Ring of Honor right now is the new blood or is part of the new blood of professional wrestling? Because these are the kids who are not getting it. Okay, granted, they're on national courtesy of the Sinclair Broadcast Group, but still, SBG is not in all the major markets. I mean, granted, we get them here in Birmingham and the shows air twice within 24 hours, 36 hours, and I enjoy watching it, but I mean, I really have to sit back and say, as far as and looking at what's happened with some of the signings from WWE, honestly, I would have to sit back. Do you agree or disagree that right now Ring of Honor would be considered the new blood?
FCW seems like it's just a few of the guys from Ring of Honor. It's like your next step after Ring of Honor is FCW before WWE. A lot of those guys have come and made names for themselves or on the verge of it. FCW is putting on a far superior product than SmackDown and Raw. Every NXT show that I watch online is better and better and better. The commentary is better. I don't even know who the hell that guy is, William Regal, but he's damn good. So, Ring of Honor would have to be. The de facto, it would be like the developmental league, if you will.
Yeah.
But they are the backbone of the new age of wrestling, so to speak.
Mabo, did you find what you were looking for?
I have seen late April, early May. That's pretty much all I'm getting. But I do agree with Wicked how, Ring of Honor is the backbone of FCW, and then that's where they filter out who's going to stay, who's officially getting signed, and who can go. I mean, if you look at it, guys like Jon Moxley, guys like Chris Hero and Claudio have all come from, and Tyler Black all came from Ring of Honor. As everybody knows, CM Punk, Daniel Bryan, Ring of Honor. you know, if he made his decision, but at one point it could have been Samoa Joe, Colt Cabana. He was Ring of Honor before he went down to FCW.
Braden Walker.
No. That was TNA.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, poor Chris Harris. Where have you gone? Oh, wait, nobody cares. But it's much like, you know, how back in the day when OVW was the developmental camp, but, you know, guys like John Cena came from UPW, Molina came from UPW, Mike Knox came from UPW. Mike Knox came from Molina, or what? No. You know, there's a lot of places that fed from, you know, it fed into OVW, like UPW. I believe even Memphis, when it got kind of, I'm not going to say downgraded, but, you know.
You can use that word.
Well, I guess it was downgraded because everybody remembers back in the day, you went through Lawler's territory, Memphis, to get to the WWE. That and the Funkin' Conservatory, run by Dory Funk. All those places, you know, at Heartland, all those places started funneling talent into OVW. So, you know, that's where people were, you know, steeled and picked out and then called up. And the same thing can be said for FCW and Ring of Honor. I mean, it's almost like Vince is picking the best from the independents and putting them in FCW, and it seems like the, you know, the rich, lush field to harvest, you know, the best produce from is Ring of Honor. Of course, then he turns around and gives them stupid gimmicks, but, you know, hey, whatever.
Welcome to Vince Land. Welcome to Vinny World. That's it.
Yeah, and speaking of, and I hate to steal this from the WWE, one of my favorite WWE YouTube shows, Are You Serious? But Lord Tensai, are you serious?
I was hoping we'd get through the show without discussing that, but go ahead.
Oh, Albert, A-Train, Hip Hop Hippo.
Hungry Hippo.
Giant Bernard, oh my God.
See, therein lies the funny part, because I'm going to go ahead and jump on this one real quick. I wish that they had left the hood on him for about a month. Let him come out, let him be dominant, but okay, the internet and everybody talking on it, he's on the contract, he's going to be there tonight, just like Brock Lesnar. Brock Lesnar's going to be on Raw Monday because he signed the contract on Sunday, and WWE's going to jump him right on out there. Brock Lesnar looked like crap, by the way. And I'm just...
Don't worry, he'll gas up, and he'll be ready in about a month or two.
I give him 8 weeks, yeah. Especially if Triple H and Sheamus are his workout partners. Oh, my God. This boy's in trouble again. But... look, I just, there are times when I like to be surprised, and I like to stay spoiler free, just like Mabo and occasionally Wicked Nemesis. We like to be able to see things the first time out, and it's kind of hard to do when you got as many people following as you do on Facebook and on Twitter and everything else. It's just, but the thing about it is, there are some people out in the world on the rag sheets and crap like that who have no respect, period. You have people running shows and people running websites who've never stepped foot in the locker room, in the ring to train, much less to work. And I'm gonna be the one to blow the cover off the business. Guess what, dipstick? You're not the only one trying, and if you actually had a clue and a little bit of respect for the business for which you call yourself a fan, you wouldn't be doing crap like that. Wicked, agree or disagree?
Oh, you can get me riled up right here before the top of the hour.
Speaking of, before we go any further, we have not had a chance to talk before the show went on live, and I forgot to do it during the last break. Are both of y'all going to be coming back around 7:30 when we wrap up the interview with Elder, or are both of y'all going to sign out at 7? Wicked?
Oh, I'm out at 7, sir.
Okay, Mabo?
I'll come back and close the show with you.
Okay, cool. I'll keep you in the loop. We could go ahead and give me go ahead and follow up on what I was saying, and go. I'll let you go ahead and pop shameless plugs too, because we're four before the top of the hour.
Well, it just comes to the point that, you know, I knew that Lesnar was in Miami, but I tried to stay away from spoilers as much as possible. I don't read any of the SmackDown spoilers. I don't go looking for spoilers at all, and I can't stand people that put them out there. For whatever reason, it happens.
But Lesnar, I didn't like the fact that he picked up John Cena and then walked around and showed him. And Cena didn't even fight back. Cena should at least throw some elbows and did something. I thought that made Cena look weak. But Lesnar did get a big reaction. And all I've got to say about that is, yes, yes, yes. You can find me on Twitter at Wicked Nemesis, Facebook fan page Wicked Nemesis Enoch, E-N-O-C-H, Tessarian, T-S-A-R-I-O-N, Wicked Nemesis Enoch on VO, Daily Motion, YouTube, Blogger, Blogspot, Funny or Die. I think that's it.
You got ahead of yourself, didn't you?
Yeah, I got really fast. I've gotten really good at it. But anybody, if you want to send me videos to get bookings, Enoch at thewickedmenaces.com to get in contact with me. And let's just say what it is. Monday Night Raw was better than WrestleMania. I gave Monday Night Raw a 4.5, and I gave WrestleMania a 4 out of 5.
Now, before I throw to Mabo, I'm going to ask you both real quick, and this is going to go into the new category of the power of a minute. It was made public earlier this week that the gentleman who defeated Brock Lesnar inside the cage, Alistair Overeem, was found to be guilty of steroid use in a surprise blood test or a surprise test. Knowing this the way we do and knowing the circuit the way we do, and matter of fact, I'm going to get a chance to talk to Vicky Jackson about this a little bit later on in the broadcast. How does that make you feel about the factor of Lesnar's last fight when Overeem threw the leg the way he did? And also, it was noticeable that, okay, I'm going to say this, Lesnar threw the damn fight. I have to stand beside that. But noting the fact that Overeem's been found, he got popped for roid use, how does that make you feel about Lesnar's last fight? Mabo.
I think it's terrible. I mean, it's all fake anyway, so what does it matter?
Yeah, I know. USC is fake. The indies are real.
I'd say WWE's more real than the freaking UFC. At least WWE sits there and goes, yeah, we do script these things, but the hitting's real. At least they say that. I mean, come on. UFC's like, no, it's all real. And I'm Irish. Top of the morning, I tell you.
Mabo, shameless plugs real quick. Throw them out there.
I thought I was going to come back later on.
Well, you are, but still.
Why would I want to plug myself twice? I only like to be plugged once.
Friday night, WA Pro South Piedmont, Alabama. Saturday night, Peach State Wrestling Alliance. Where? Carrollton,
it was in Georgia.
You guys can make this. This is not a weekend to be missed. I promise you. You think for all my followers that this weekend was wild? No. Next weekend is going to be the wildest. It's going to be Wild and Crazy Kids for those of you that remember that show on Nickelodeon.
Yeah.
When do we go back to Mumford?
The 28th.
The 28th? Oh, boy.
Okay, I got to make sure Tunzi's available.
There you go. Folks, we're going to head to the top of the hour break at this point. Like I said, Wicked's about to sign off. Be sure to join him on Shoot Finish Radio Wednesday nights at 9 o'clock, isn't it? 9 o'clock Central? Wicked.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure I got the time right, because I keep forgetting Mountain versus Central. I mean, Eastern versus Central every once in a while. And Mabo said he'll be rejoining us probably around 7:35, so we're going to go ahead and take it to the top of the hour break. Folks, you are listening to Beyond Ringside.
This is Ace Haven from Pro South Wrestling, and you're locked in to Beyond Ringside.
Confessions of a Potentially Perfect Parent, brought to you by AdoptUsKids.org.
I don't know how to talk like a parent. Don't make me come back there. You see what I mean? It's pretty awful. Try it again. Don't make me come back there. Now that's pretty good. That one kind of sounded like my dad. Weird.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you. Call 1-888-200-4005 or visit AdoptUsKids.org for more information. A message from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Adopt Us Kids, and the Ad Council.
This is Bad Brad Armstrong, part of the famous Armstrong family of professional wrestling, and you're locked in to Beyond Ringside.
Hi, this is Joe Perry.
And Steven Tyler of Aerosmith for Red. You know, it's okay to rock and roll and party down. Just don't get in that 2,000-pound bullet when you're done and cocked. And please don't drink and drive.
I'm the one that jaded you.
A reminder that friends don't let friends drive drunk. A public service message brought to you by the Ad Council, U.S. Department of Transportation, National Association of Broadcasters, and RAD.
This is El Professor from the Santa Clara Colony in Mexico. And you are locked in to Beyond Ringside, yes. Salagadoola,
Mitchigaboola. You must be your fairy godmother. Yes.
It doesn't take a fairy godmother to tell you that the right fit means everything.
Good heavens, child. You can't go in that.
Children under 4'9" need to be in a booster seat because they aren't ready for adult safety belts alone. Remember that 4'9" is the magic number. And get your little pumpkin there safely in a booster seat.
Oh, thank you.
For more information, visit boosterseat.gov. This has been a message from the U.S. Department of Transportation and the Ad Council.
This is Brian Alexander, Alexander the Great. You're locked in to Beyond Ringside.
Charlie!
Hey, did you see that play last night?
Unbelievable.
Yeah, and they still lost. Sure. You know, when I was playing, what we
what?
Tried to...
What? You played in the street.
I played in the service.
Oh,
anyway,
oh.
What I'm trying to say is the kid, he should have... He
yeah, he... Hey, you okay?
I don't...
Someone call 911!
2 out of 3 people with diabetes die of a heart attack or stroke, but you can lower the risk. Ask your healthcare provider how. For more info, go to diabetesactnow.org. Brought to you by the American Diabetes Association and the Ad Council.
This is Jeff Munson, and you're locked into the On Ring Side.
Hey parents, introducing the Communicizer. Go from boring old man speak.
Oh, you know, I'm here if you want to talk.
To 100% off the chain.
Text me whenever, yo.
I love you, Dad.
Communicizer is not available in stores because it doesn't exist. But that's okay. You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Because kids in foster care don't need perfection. They need you. For more information on how you can adopt, go to AdoptUsKids.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Adopt Us Kids, and the Ad Council.
This is the greatest wrestler the world has ever known, the magnificent J.P. Magnum, and you're locked in to be on ringside.
Hi, this is Emily Richards for RAD, recording artists, actors, and athletes against drunk driving. One person's negligence shattered my life in a single instant. You see, my little sister Annie was killed by a drunk driver. Please, remember those you love. Friends don't let friends drive drunk.
A public service announcement brought to you by the U.S. Department of Transportation, RAD, the National Association of Broadcasters, and the Ad Council.
Hey people, this is the Machine Guff Grayson, live and in your face. And remember, you are locked in to Beyond Ringside.
My name is Mary Crafts, and this is how I live United. I spent the last 24 years serving others in my catering company, but I felt that a huge part of our community was still being underserved, those invisible children and young families. With United Way, I advocate for them any way I can. As a volunteer, I go into people's homes and assess mother and infant well-being and help bring change and opportunity into their lives. Nothing feels as good as helping, so I don't just wear the shirt, I live it.
Give, advocate, volunteer, live United. Go to liveunited.org. Brought to you by United Way and the Ad Council.
This is Hector Camacho Jr., and you are locked in with Beyond Ringside. History is on.
Hi, I'm Drew Brees, NFL quarterback for the New Orleans Saints, here with Bugs Bunny to remind you to get moving every day.
Because when you get moving an hour a day,
you fuel your body and your mind.
So what do you like to throw around the football like Drew?
Skateboard, ride a bike, or dance in your room.
Just move it your way.
And be a player.
Get up and play an hour a day, Doc. Check out how to be a player at letsmove.gov.
Head online to get tips on great ways to get moving every day.
At letsmove.gov. A message from the Ad Council and HHS.
This is Howard C. Cross, the Legal Eagle, and you're listening to Beyond Ringside.
As a mother, I'm making it a point to get the H1N1 flu vaccine for my children. You see, children are especially vulnerable to serious complications from the H1N1 flu, which could lead to hospitalization and even death. That's why I'm urging parents to get their children vaccinated. Vaccination is safe and is the most effective way to prevent the flu. Get the facts at flu.gov. Together, we can all fight the flu.
A public service announcement brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
This is the tailor-made man, Micah Taylor. All right, and you're locked in to Beyond Ringside.
Start your engines.
Hi, this is Eric Darnell.
This is David Reagan.
Jamie McMurray.
This is Carl Edwards here for RED,
the entertainment industry's voice for road safety.
Want to make a difference? It's simple. Be responsible.
Plan ahead. Designate before you celebrate.
Friends don't let friends drive drunk.
A public service message brought to you by the U.S. Department of Transportation, RAD, the National Association of Broadcasters, and the Ad Council.
When planning your next party or special event, insist on the best. 4-Range Entertainment is a professional entertainment company providing a full range of services. From professional disc jockeys and MCs to catering and photography, when the details of your special day must be perfect, call us first. Wedding receptions, corporate parties, school functions, birthday celebrations, and more. We also have Birmingham's largest selection of karaoke tracks available. With over 40 years combined experience, 4-Range Entertainment can provide you with the talent and professionalism you need and deserve to make your next event one you'll never forget. For more information on the full range of services we offer, call 533-HITS, that's 533-HITS, or check us out on our website at fullrangeentertainment.com.
This is Angel Orsini.
This is the Human Hand Grenade, Danny Only.
This is Dirty Dutch Mantel.
This is Liz Savage.
This is Vinnie O'Brien, 2010 Golden Glove Champion.
This is Gabe Sapolsky from Dragon Gate USA and Evolve Pro Wrestling, and you're locked into Beyond Ringside.
Welcome to the original Rockin' Wrestling Radio Show. Welcome to Beyond Ringside, your source for wrestling, MMA, and boxing in the Southeast. To contact the Ringside Roundtable of Beyond Ringside, email them at beyondringside@gmail.com. And now, your host for Beyond Ringside, the man, no myth, all legend, Fast Eddie Lane.
On a beautiful Easter Sunday. At least it has been where I've been from, and that's because I've been asleep half the day. Thank you, Exhaustion. You're a good friend of mine. Welcome into Beyond Ringside, live from the vault in the 4-Range Entertainment Studios. Thank you, Mike Macaroni, the cheesiest announcer in the business. Always great to hear your voice. Mark Bowman going to be rejoining the cast in just a little while. Thank you, of course, to tag team partner, the Oracle of Ominous, the Wicked Nemesis, will be rejoining us next week. And once again, catch him Wednesday nights on Shoot Finish Radio. As we are set and ready to roll, taking things into a slightly different gear right now, of course, around the Radio Ranch. Like to welcome in one of our favorite, if not our genuine favorite, MMA reporter, Vicky Jackson. How you doing today?
Hey, y'all. I'm doing great.
The consummate Southern Belle. That's the easy way to describe Vicky. And like to welcome in one of our new best friends with Strike Hard Productions, David Elder. How you doing today?
Hey, I'm doing great. Good to hear you, Vicky.
Good to, you can hear me, Dave.
I'm glad I can hear.
And actually, I'll go and clue everybody in. There's a little bit of an inside. That is actually a little bit of an inside joke, and I'm going to break kayfabe on that one real quick. Actually, David suffered a little bit of an inner ear problem a little bit earlier today, and he's right now waiting on medical attention. But being the professional promoter, you're doggone right. He made the show.
We always make the show.
There you go. The show can and will go on, and we're glad to have you on. Now, I've heard a number of different shows since Beyond Ringside made its return a few years ago. Vicky's always been really good about sending us information. Plus, I do a lot of scouting around myself to find out about different shows that are going on, especially in our home state of Alabama. And I've heard a lot of great things coming out of Strike Hard. And looking forward to it. You've got an event coming up this coming Saturday night, April the 14th. And do me a favor, give us a little bit of information on it.
Yeah, we're going to be here in our new Killer Buzz Arena, which seats about 2,500. It's the old Sticks and Stuff building in the Matt Farland Mall right off the interstate on Matt Farland Boulevard. So we're real excited about this venue. This will be our second fight in the venue.
Now, for those who don't know, how long has Strike Hard been around?
Oh, goodness. Well, this is our 15th fight. We took about a two-year break waiting on the commission, so I would say probably about five and a half years.
Now, we've been following the world of mixed martial arts in addition to the world of professional wrestling and prize fighting around here, and we of course had a very strong eye and unwavering eye on the Alabama Athletic Commission from its formation originally as the Alabama Boxing Commission. And then when they added the world of MMA under their umbrella, we're sitting back looking at the overall situation going, how is this going to pan out? How is this going to work out? I'm not going to put you on the spot, but I'm going to ask, knowing the factor that ISKA, or a lot of people just go ahead and shoot the acronym and go ISKA, they'll sit back and they'll be a little bit trepidatious about the certain aspects of it. Now, before everything kicked over, a lot of companies were following, per se, Georgia rules as far as their state athletic commission. Some were following Tennessee. Before everything kicked in, which way did you lean?
I probably lean closer to our show's probably went a little closer to what Mississippi's doing now. You know, we didn't have the shin pads, and we allowed elbows and knees, so it was closer to you know, professional style rules. But we always had the doctors and the ambulances and professional people around in our venues. We just went more with a professional style MMA program.
Now, Strikecard 15, of course, this coming Saturday night, April the 14th, from the Killer Buzz Arena. This is going to be an all-amateur show, right?
This will be an all-amateur show. We're hoping to do a pro-am show sometime later in the summer.
Okay. Now, excluding this upcoming event, for the MMA fans around the Southeast and here in our home state of Alabama, give us some of the names that have come through your doors before this event.
Some of you guys heard of Chris Davis, yeah, who has fought on Bellator, and he'll be fighting on Bellator, I believe, coming up next month. He's had a very good career. A lot of the Alabama guys will know John Salter. John's never fought with us before, but he's judged for us and been in a lot of our shows. He trained right here out of Tuscaloosa, where we're based out of, for probably about a year and a half at Headhunter Combatants. So those are two of the biggest name guys probably that's come through.
Now, I'm going to ask you right off the bat, moving into this coming Saturday night, can you give me a roundabout number of how many different dojos and, like I said, it's a brand new tongue. I'm still trying to break it in. And you're working on Killer Buzz, and I've got a green monster sitting over here. Love you, Killer Buzz. It's really cool. That's not a big fan of the on-tap version. I like the can version. Thanks, Vic. And how many different dojos do you have represented coming into this event?
This event, we probably got about six different camps coming in here. They're coming in from Tennessee. We've got Brian Russell bringing a 170-pounder, Dylan Gibson, in for his first fight. He's going to be facing Robert Terrell, who lost his first fight against one of Roy Singer's guys out of Georgia last month. He's coming in from Tennessee. We got some guys around here. Headhunters has got four guys on the card, and we're real excited about them. They've got two exciting, explosive 185ers. They've got a new 155er, Mark Holt, that was a walk-on at Alabama. He is in incredible shape. He's going to be new into the cage, but I've seen him train. He's pretty explosive.
Now, one thing, and Vicky, I'm about to invite you into the whole end of the loop. One thing that I've noticed on the different shows, and like I said, we've been covering for a while. I've had the privilege of seeing a number of different shows around the southeastern U.S., my home base. And you have some that are very quick to say, yes, I represent this dojo. I represent this this gym and this team. And you've got a number of people who are basically, to use a very loose term, more eclectic, so to speak. They're self-taught, they're self-trained, or at least they don't really give credit to or they don't really claim a dojo or a gym. How do you feel that those fighters genuinely fare in the amateur as well as in the professional side?
You asking me that?
Yes.
Well, you know, that's a hard question, because I would say 9 times out of 10, somebody's associated with a good gym or dojo tends to do better than somebody that is, you know, trained by themselves. But over the last year, we've lost a lot of camps. A lot of the smaller camps have kind of gone away. They had nowhere to fight here in the state.
Right.
And so we're kind of seeing a little bit more of that right now than we normally would. I think that's going to be changing over the next few months.
Now, the event coming up this coming Saturday night, the doors are going to open, I do believe you said, at 6 o'clock p.m.
And that is correct.
First match is scheduled to go at 7 o'clock p.m.
That is correct.
What is your ticket price and the availability right now?
Well, right now we just added about 8 new bleacher sets that really gives us a stadium-style effect.
Nice.
And we hold about 2,500, and we've sold about 550 tickets right now, which is pretty good for us, you know, considering we just started our real public advertising this weekend. So the DJ Tater Cody Easton fight's been a fight that we've had scheduled. We had it scheduled 2 years ago when the commission started, and so we've waited 2 years to put this fight on. and there's a lot of people in the state want to see this fight happen.
I've heard both names. I've heard a lot about both individuals, and if I were able to, definitely this would be one that I would be, I'm paying very close attention to on my side of the board. Vicki Jackson, come on in.
Well, hey there, y'all.
Vicki, just
just for future reference, those are called independents.
Okay.
That's kind of what they call them. The ones that maybe are, you know, training at home or training, you know, at a friend's house or doing something like that. In the MMA world, they're referred to as independent fighters.
I knew that, but by the same token, see, here's the thing about it. And you have people who work as teams, you have people who work as independents, but also, for some reason, over the years, it takes a more eclectic personality. And that's why I personally went in that direction as far as the terminology.
Yeah.
Because you've got some people who do play well with others, and you have those who don't play well with others. That's the easy way to say it.
Well, you get into all that self-discipline and stuff, so that means a lot.
There you go. Now, I know that you've got a number of questions about the upcoming show, right?
Me?
You.
I don't really know that I have a lot of questions. I've kind of been helping Strike Guard get their show together a little bit. So I know a lot of stuff, but some of the questions that I, you know, of course, I'm always curious about exactly what the fight card is going to be. I know some of the fights and some of the fighters, but, you know, I always like to see the final matches.
Okay. David, how many of the fights? Now, you said you've got 12 fights confirmed for this show at this point. Now, understanding the fact that there's always a little asterisk at the bottom in every professional sport and amateur sport, subject to change without notice.
That's exactly right. Especially when you deal with amateurs. And, you know, that's why we are somewhat hesitant about putting these cards out. You know, it creates sometimes a little added drama when you change an opponent. You know, whatever the circumstances may be. So, you know, I like to let the main events out and the undercards, we kind of hold on to a little bit.
Understand that concept. Now, the Cody East and DJ Taylor fight, like I said, I've had a chance to do a little bit of homework. Now, I don't necessarily want to totally compare notes, but give me a little bit of a background about the two fighting styles and let everybody know who hasn't had a chance to fight. To hear about the two gentlemen.
Well, DJ Taylor is our super heavyweight and our heavyweight champion. He's stands about 5'11", right about the 200. Well, he used to fight about 280. He is in incredible shape right now, and we're holding him steady at about 270 pounds. He is a brawler. He's good off his back, but he is really good standing up. Really strong stand-up game, punching-wise. He's knocked all of his opponents out, with the exception of his one loss was to Chris Davis, the Bellator fighter, in which he tore a bicep muscle in the first round and never quit the fight, but lost to a rear-naked choke because he only had one arm. So he is a tough, tough character and draws a huge fan base. Cody Eason, on the other side, is 6'4", 350 pounds. He's a police officer, and he's won two by knockout, one by submission, and he has a phenomenal ground game. He competes in a lot of Luchador grappling tournaments, Naga grappling tournaments. He is a big guy, and he's going to be a lot to handle for DJ. You know, this fight could go one of two ways. 50% of the people think DJ will knock him out. The other 50% believe that if it goes to the ground, Cody will get a submission or a tap out due to strikes.
Hmm.
So it's one to watch. I can't call it. It's fun. This is the kind of fight you like to promote.
Yeah, because when you've got a situation where you've got all combustible elements in place and they're volatile elements at that, especially when they've been waiting for a fight and waiting for this fight and this opportunity to showcase their talents and also to quell a lot of the rumors that fly around from all the different fans and all the different writers and journalists in the that follow the industry, it's like we're finally going to get a chance to shut somebody up.
Well, that's exactly right. DJ's nickname is called The Hype, and Cody, he loves to talk. DJ doesn't talk very much at all. Cody loves to talk. and he has a tremendous fan base. And Facebook's been blowing up, you know, for about 8 weeks since we announced the date of the card. And, you know, it's going to be one to watch for sure.
Now, in another one of the fights that you've got coming up in the 170 classifications, you've actually got cousins who are going to be facing each other, right?
I sure do. I've got Chris Johnson versus Bradley Johnson, and Bradley has the better record of the two. But Bradley has been more of a kind of an independent type trained guy. He's with a Team Fame, but they don't have a gym right now, and you know, they're struggling through getting started again. Chris Johnson, on the other hand, has stayed with Headhunter for the last several years. He's has a record of 6-3 and wants to go ahead and go pro. He's got a pretty good stand-up game, but he's a purple belt in jiu-jitsu. So this fight could go either way. This fight's kind of in the same predicament as DJ and Cody, as far as Bradley is probably noted as a better stand-up fighter, and Chris Johnson's better noted as the better jiu-jitsu practitioner. But Chris Johnson also has our record over the 15 fight or 14 fights up to this point. He has an 11-second knockout.
Now, give me an idea of some of the other fights that are taking place on the show next Saturday night.
Well, one that the whole state's looking forward to is to see Matt Ward get to fight. A few weeks ago, he didn't get to fight on the Sport Fight X card, and I felt bad for him and Sport Fight X. That I know they did everything they could do to make the fight happen.
They did.
It's not their fault, you know, but the fight didn't get to happen. And so he's fighting a guy named Jay Wilson on this card from Gulf Shores, Alabama. And that's going to be one to watch, obviously. He's probably thought of as one of the best 170s in our state,
mm-hmm.
and he's fighting at 185 this time, so he's not really cutting any weight here. We also have another fight. Riley Matheson is fighting on this card, and that's interesting to watch because Matt Ward and Riley were originally supposed to fight on the Sport Fight X card, and when we had to move our date back, Riley was already in contract with us, and so he couldn't take the Sport Fight X card, and so that added a little bit to the controversy, I guess, of him not having a fight, but not really. It was another guy, you know, that was involved there that I don't know. But so Riley and Matt are both fighting different opponents on this card, and I know in the future, somewhere in the near future, they will fight in the state of Alabama, and I hope it's with us. So that's going to be a big one to watch. Obviously, Mark Holt, the former University of Alabama defensive back, he was a walk-on guy, real, real tough guy, CrossFit competitor, amazing condition. He's going to be one to watch. And then B.J. Webb, he fought his first fight for us last month, and he's out of Headhunter Combatives. He's fighting Dakota Hollingsworth, and B.J. won in the first round last month with an armbar, but he is a very explosive fighter. Can't wait to see him again. Matt Hobson is coming back. He used to train, I believe, with Spartan. He is with the Wolfpack, and he's going to be fighting at 185 on this card. That's going to be exciting to watch, too. So we got some good ones on the card.
It really sounds like it. And you told me the tickets are $30 general admission, right?
$30 general admission. That's right.
Now, this is something that I've always said, and this is something that I preach on this show. Mm-hmm. When you sit back and you're at home and you pay $29.95 for a pay-per-view that is maybe going to feature five fights on it, or if you're going to your local sports bar, in my case, like Buffalo Wild Wings in Alabaster or Hoover, that particular national promotion that does pay-per-views and has been running way too many as of late up until recently when they finally took a 4-week break. However, that's a subject for another time. I've been very vocal about that too. But you've got an opportunity to be live at an event where, now, once again, subject to change, because here's the thing about it. And this is a straight shoot for everybody all the way across the board. And David understands this. Vicky knows it to be fact as well. When you have guys who are training so hard and so passionately for an event like this on the 14th, sometimes things happen and injuries can mount up to where they're not able to. But you know that these guys are in there, in the gyms, in their dojos, and they are working to hone their craft. They're working to get their timing down. They're working to build their strength, keep their endurance for a fight just like this. And for a general admission ticket price of only $30, I did put that word only in front of it for a reason. Even if they lose one of the fights, that's going to give them 11 fights on this card. Stack that up against anything that you're going to watch on pay-per-view, whether from that three-letter company, and I guarantee you are going to have a better time live at an event like this than you will sitting back watching a that national promotion. So for our friends in the Central Alabama area, Eastern Mississippi, Western Georgia, you are going to be in for a treat, because I know a lot of the names that are going to be on this card. I've had a chance to see a number of them. And you are going to have a chance to see some great amateur fights. Now, remembering the fact, there is a slight difference in the Alabama situation due to the fact that we've adopted ISKA rulings. Basically, a lot of the Muay Thai has been thrown out. They are wearing the shin guards. And there's a couple other small variances between, like, Mississippi, Georgia, Tennessee, unless they're following the ISKA rules as well. See, I went ahead and said ISKA that time anyway. For those who don't think, I just want to jump on that one. But I will say it like this. Regardless, you've got fighters who are going in there and giving it everything to showcase their talents, their ability, because they want to get ready to make that move to professional and become noticed that much more. David, agree or disagree?
I totally agree. I appreciate the plug, too. And, you know, these guys do put it all on the line. And, you know, going into it, I was real sketchy about whether I would like the ISKA rules. And you know, I'll be honest with you, after we had our first fight, it really comes down to matchmaking. And if you got two equally matched guys in there, it is an explosive fight to watch. And whether they have shin pads on or not, you know, it still hurts. It still knocks guys out. You know, it's a wonderful thing. You won't be disappointed to come down here. And when you look at a $30 ticket price, you're looking at $2.50 a fight.
Mm-hmm.
You know, anybody would pay $2.50 to see a good, equally matched fight.
Yeah.
You know? And that's not all we have. We've got our fighters love, we got a 40-foot stage they come out on, two jumbotrons on the side, a full light show. It's just a really nice setup, and we rented the whole building, so we don't have to take our chairs and tables and cage down. It stays set up all the time, so we get to add to it. And every show, we have seven shows scheduled between March and the last weekend in August, and we'll be fighting every month. But you know, we're adding a little bit more each month to our show, and you know, it's just well worth the ticket price, and these guys do. You know, our fans have always been wonderful about screaming and hollering and letting the guys know how much that they appreciate them. And we got a pretty knowledgeable fan base here in Tuscaloosa. So fighters really like to come here because people are hollering for them the whole time. You just don't have any dead moments.
Hey, Vicky, before we head to break, let me go and toss it back over in your direction. Questions you'd like to ask David right now?
You know, I don't really have any questions. Like I said, I've been helping him do a few things to get ready. I'm very, very excited about the show that's coming up this weekend. I'm going to try to be over there Friday night for weigh-ins, and then Saturday, probably just about all day from lunchtime on. They've got great fighters, a great setup. They got music, food, t-shirts. I mean, you know, I just love it. I love the whole atmosphere. It's just great, and I plan on being there.
And here's always...
it's going to be fun.
Here's always the fun part for the promoter. Time to show the love for the sponsors, my friend.
Oh, well, we really appreciate Killer Buzz and No Limit Customs. You know, without Killer Buzz helping us, there's no way that our venue, there's no venues here in Tuscaloosa to have, and without Killer Buzz opening up this arena to us, there's no way that we could even put on a fight. So thanks to Stan Pate and Killer Buzz, that is a true asset to the MMA community and to StrikeCard, as well as No Limit Customs here in Tuscaloosa. They're a nonprofit organization And they have gone out and worked endlessly over the last five or six promotions we've had over the last 3 years to help us promote our sport, to help MMA. They're on Facebook constantly. They put out posters and flyers and banners and helped us sell tickets. And so we really want to shout out the love for No Limit Customs. And those are the two big ones right now, and we certainly appreciate them.
Folks, mark your calendar, make your plans. Saturday, April the 14th, Tuscaloosa, Alabama at the Killer Buzz Arena, formerly known as the McFarland Mall. Strike Hard Productions, Strike Hard Mixed Martial Arts, Strike Hard 15. 6 p.m. when the door's going to open, 7 p.m. first fight scheduled. Subject to change, maybe 5 minutes. Patients, children, that's all I can say. It's a live event. Things happen. Trust me, I know for a fact that things happen. General admission seating, very much available. $30 tickets available in advance and at the door. And it's just that easy. A website where everybody can find all the information.
Yeah, they can go to our Facebook page at Strike Hard Productions. Become a fan. And you can buy your tickets on Facebook. Go to the event tag on our Facebook page. You can buy your tickets right there.
Definite plan. David, the door is always open. Anytime you've got something going on with Strike Hard, all you got to do, shoot me a message, let me know. You've got my cell phone number, catch me on text, and we can set it up for you to slide back in, and we'll get, like I said, when this one's in the books. Vicky, you're going to be at the event, right?
I am. I'll be there.
And we'll definitely be keeping an ear out for Vicky as far as giving us a wrap from the event that's coming Saturday night. And like I said, the door is definitely open. When everything starts to come together for the next one, shoot me a message, let me know. We'll get you back in the door.
Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, our very special guest from Strike Hard Promotion, Strike Hard Mixed Martial Arts, David Elder, has just gone beyond ringside. And we will return on air right after this.
This is Kevin Kleinrock, WSX, XPW, and now Viva La Lucha, and you're locked in to Beyond Ringside.
The biggest bands in rock. The wildest stage shows on earth. The biggest live event of the summer. Everybody's gonna move their feet. Kiss and Motley Crue. Yeah. Kiss The Tour 2012. Love it doesn't get any better than this. July 31st, Oak Mountain Amphitheater. Two iconic bands. One historic tour. Kiss. Motley Crue. July 31st, Oak Mountain Amphitheater. Reserve seats are on sale now. Buy tickets at LiveNation.com or charge by phone at 800-745-3000. Kiss and Motley Crue. Buy tickets at LiveNation.com.
Come on, you need some excitement in your life.
Hey, it's Robbie Rags. Check out ragradio.com. Not only do we have great galleries, but we've got the best rock on the radio. Earth's first international rock station, breaking all the radio rules.
Robbie Rags is on Rag Radio.
Hi, I'm Drew Brees, NFL quarterback for the New Orleans Saints, here with Bugs Bunny to remind you to get moving every day.
Because when you get moving an hour a day,
you fuel your body and your mind.
So what do you like to throw around the football like Drew?
Skateboard, ride a bike, or dance in your room.
Just move it your way.
And be a player.
Get up and play an hour a day, Doc. Check out how to be a player at letsmove.gov.
Head online to get tips on great ways to get moving every day.
At letsmove.gov. A message from the Ad Council and HHS.
This is Mad Dog Dan Sawyer. You're listening to Beyond Ringside.
Confessions of a Potentially Perfect Parent, brought to you by AdoptUsKids.org.
I know more about cooking dinner for a party of 12 than about packing a lunch for a 12-year-old. I know kids like things like fish sticks. Filets, I get, but sticks? Maybe we can just compromise on mac and cheese. Can you make that with Brie?
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you. Call 1-888-200-4005 or visit AdoptUsKids.org for more information. A message from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Adopt Us Kids, and the Ad Council.
This is Michael the Godfather Gibbons, and you are listening to Beyond Ringside.
Foreclosure is hard on every member of the family, but your family is not alone. If you're struggling with your mortgage, there is help. To learn about the government's Making Home Affordable program, visit makinghomeaffordable.gov or call 1-888-995-HOPE to speak to a HUD-approved housing counselor. It's free of charge. Visit MakingHomeAffordable.gov or call 1-888-995-HOPE today. Brought to you by the U.S. Treasury, HUD, NeighborWorks America, and the Ad Council.
This is Liz Savage. You can check me out at www.myspace.com/wrestlingdiva. And you're listening to Beyond Ringside.
Hi, this is Joe Elliott from Def Leppard for Rad. Planning on going out and having a party? Great, have a lot of fun. But do me a big favor and don't blow it. Always choose a designated driver. Remember, music lives. You should too.
A public service message brought to you by the U.S. Department of Transportation, RAD, the National Association of Broadcasters, and the Ad Council.
This is Dale the Demon Torborg, and you're locked in to Beyond Ringside.
Hello, this is Robin Zanner.
Hello, this is Rick Nielsen from Cheap Trick for RAD.
Some people think it's fun to drive drunk, but that's unacceptable.
Be smart. If you drink,
don't drive.
Think ahead and choose a designated driver. Remember, music lives, and so should you.
A public service message brought to you by the U.S. Department of Transportation, RAD, the National Association of Broadcasters, and the Ad Council.
You have tuned in and are now live listening to the three-time NWA Heavyweight Champion of the World, Scrapper Adam Pearce. And just like you, I am also locked in. And brother, we are beyond ringside.
Citizens of America, this is a message from FeedThePig.org. Americans spent more money than they earned in 2005. This is the first negative savings rate in the U.S. since the Great Depression. America, we must start feeding the pig. On the 1st and the 15th, we must pay ourselves before we pay anyone or anything. We must make a budget. Even consider cutting up a credit card. Log on to FeedThePig.org today. Find the benefits of saving for every stage of life. Brought to you by the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants and the Ad Council.
This is Theodore Tutwiler III, the Cock of the Walk, and you're locked in to Beyond Ringside.
On a slamming Sunday night in more ways than one, welcome back into Beyond Ringside live from the vault. Fast Eddie Lane behind the control panel. Crazy night. Love it. Love it. Love it. Thank you to David Elder for coming on with us from Strike Hard Productions. Great to have him on board. Looking forward to hearing everything coming out of the show next Saturday night, April the 14th, Tuscaloosa, Alabama, at the Killer Buzz Arena, formerly known as the McFarland Mall. Looking forward to it. Strike Hard 15. It's going to be a great show. Vicki Jackson, welcome back in.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Now, you have actually been a very, very, matter of fact, speaking of welcoming back in, Maybo, come on back in, Mark Bowman.
Why?
Because you can.
Because we want you to.
But you're going to call me or text me.
I was about to. But before
I... Are we on air?
Yes, we are actually, sir. And the reason why I was actually holding for just a second is because I know Vicki has been not necessarily the social butterfly, but definitely the journalistic butterfly. You've been more places over the last few weeks than I've got active brain cells.
Well, you know, that's why I started drinking those Killer Buzz drinks, because, and hey, I'm planning on getting the hook up Saturday when I'm over at Strike Bar, because you can drink those Killer Buzz drinks, and buddy, you can just go.
And you're now officially in charge of getting Killer Buzz on as a sponsor Beyond Ringside.
I'll do it. Hey, I'll just flat do it. I'm here to tell you.
Tell them they got a long road to hoe to get me off Green Monster, though, but I'm always open for a new energy drink. Kind of like Maybo is every once in a while, even though he's got to wait a few weeks on one, right?
Yeah, buddy.
Now, Vicki, real quick, while we've got a second, let me go ahead and ask some of the shows that you've been to. I know you and I were together up at the Sport Fight X show a few weeks ago up in Huntsville, Alabama. And I'm still riding high on the cloud from that one. A tremendous experience. Thank you to Adam Gibbs for having me on board with the broadcast team. It was a tremendous honor and a privilege. And as a journalist, I know you were having a blast with the fights.
I had an awesome time that night.
I think even Maybo would have had a good time at that show.
Well, Maybo's going to have to go next time.
Maybo, where are you going to be next Saturday night?
not at a strike hard event?
Oh, boobies,
I can't believe I heard that.
Hey, look, unless you can guarantee me getting paid, made, or laid, sorry.
And that's why he still goes to pro wrestling shows, because he doesn't get it there either.
No. Not really. I just go to try to support my alleged friends who think they've got a good thing going, when actually they're just kind of sad, really.
Oh, I know I am, but still. Meanwhile, back at the ranch.
I didn't say I was talking about you, Poogie.
Oh, okay. Okay. Now, sliding back over for a second, Vicky, give it, what other shows have you managed to make it out to covering them?
Well, you know, we had the AXC show up in Coleman, which is always a great card. We had that. Actually, it was following the last Sport FedEx show that you were being. We had that one. We had Flatline Fights up in Sheffield last night, and now we got Strike Card next weekend. So this will be two fights that you've missed at Sport FedEx.
Okay.
Yeah.
There's been so many things going on lately. Now, I know that in the new era, that's AXC's second event, right?
Yes, it is. And this time at their second event, they actually had pay-per-view. You could purchase the fights on the internet and watch them at home. So that was really new for AXC, too, to be able to do the internet pay-per-view and, you know, buy the fights at your house. So that was really exciting for that amateur show to get that thing that was, you know, that capability for them, I should say.
Now, were they on Go Fight Live as well?
No, they were on an easy stream, I believe. They weren't on GFL, so you can actually go to AXC. It's www.axcfights.com, and it leads you right to their pay-per-view stream so that you can purchase the last fights there in case you wanted to, Eddie, since you missed them last time.
Yeah, and actually, I'm the one who'll actually order the pay-per-view online, because number one, normally you get unlimited replays. It's kind of like with Mabel and myself, we talk about the Ring of Honor pay-per-views, and when you order the ROH pay-per-views, just like if you order the Sport Fight X pay-per-view, you pay the one price, you get unlimited replays, and if you're smart and know how to wire your video card directly into your DVD recorder, you have it that much easier, because you can watch it on the, you can watch it on your big screen later.
Yeah, I mean, the possibilities are endless if you're like, what's the word, engineetically or engineeringly inclined.
Technologically inclined, yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I'll teach you how to do it. I'll show you both how to do it. It's really not that hard. And there's just something about getting away from a computer for a few minutes and still actually being able to watch an event. Now, for those who have smart TVs, you know what I'm talking about, because all you have to do is run the remote control through the damn TV to begin with. I'm sorry, I don't make that much money to be able to afford toys like that yet. If I'd have won that $600 million Mega Ball, oh, trust me, we'd all be set up with big screen TVs. And I know what Mabo would be doing with it. He'd be watching the ROH pay-per-view, right, Mabo?
Nah, dude, I'd be watching porn.
There you go. I knew he was going to say it. I set him up and he went right into it, so to speak. And yes, that's what she said. However, now, Vicky, real quick, with some of the names that have been bandied about, some of the names that have already been on shows down in Tuscaloosa, up in Coleman, up in Huntsville, I know at one time you were starting to gather things for a ranking system here in state. How is that coming along?
Oh, it's coming along beautifully. I have this nice little system. I keep up with the fighters, the weights, the contact information, where they fought, when they fought, who they fought, if they won or lost. And I just keep up with all that myself. And so the fighter rankings should be coming out probably in about another month. I've had time to see the different areas of the state, you know, north, central, see all the different locations and all the different fighters. So now I actually have something that I can go by to do the rankings for around the Octagon. So that's been really exciting, and I get to keep up with everybody. So that's real fun.
Now, there's a show I'm trying to remember because I don't have my notes in front of me. A show taking place in South Alabama, right?
Do you consider Phoenix City, South Alabama?
That's central.
Okay. Well, all I knew is it was over there in Georgia. Now, there was actually a show, you're probably talking about the War One that was down in, is it Atmore?
I think so. Ardmore.
Okay, the Porch Creek Indian Reservation.
Yeah,
those,
that's it.
Those shows, those fighters will not be considered in my ranking system simply because they're not sanctioned by the state of Alabama. So they're a little bit different. But, yeah, they have World One, and they, you know, they had that down there. They have another fight, like I said, that's coming up in Phoenix City, which is a new one for the state of Alabama, a new promotion. It's called Lights Out Promotion.
Okay.
Being put on by a guy from Georgia. And that's going to be in Phoenix City, Alabama. So that's kind of a new promotion that they've got coming to the state. And I mean, just from the circles of people that I've talked to and things that I know that are going on, we have a lot of promotions from out of state that are looking to come into Alabama to put on shows in different areas such as Mobile, Auburn, Montgomery, trying to get promotions started if they're not already in different parts of the state. So that's always something that's exciting to talk about and be a part of.
Yeah, because I know that it's really a weird time in the world of mixed martial arts. It's extraordinarily promising in MMA in Alabama because of the advent of the commission and ISKA for the amateurs and the AAC for the pros. Therein lies the funny part. I'm going to ask a question of both of y'all in our own respective worlds. Now, and I'm going to go ahead and start with Vicky on this one. As a fan, more so than a journalist, when you hear of a new show coming down the pike, what is going to be the number one point for curiosity? Is it going to be trying to find out how this person runs their event? You know, because everybody's going to have a set list of guidelines from the AAC and from ISKA, but different people are going to have different marketing techniques, promotion techniques, different guidelines in play for the fighters about what they can and cannot do. Does that have anything to do with what you look at as a fan, more so than a journalist, or do you look for the name factor if they're going to be bringing in people that you know on this particular fight?
This is actually, as a fan, and this I've been thinking about this lately just because of the new promotion that's come up in Phoenix City. As a fan, the first thing I want to know is, I want to know, and I've already found that out, is who the promoter is, what kind of MMA connections they have. And then my second area of curiosity is, who are they going to have fighting for them? Because I know a lot of the fighters in this area, but what areas that they're in, you know, they may have fighters in their area I've never seen before. They may have contacts coming from different states that I've never seen before. So I really want to know who they have fighting on the fight card that I've never seen before. So I'm thinking, wow, we got a new promotion over in that side of the state. I need to go over there because they might have some great, wonderful fighters that I've never seen before that I want to be sure and see, and I want to be sure and include them in my rankings, and I want to get to know them, and I want to see what they have going on over in that part of the state. So that's kind of the thing that I look at.
Now, Mabo, I turn the same question to you as far as it goes with pro wrestling promotions, because I know you've made your way to a brand new one, your first time to a different promotion in recent history. Now, I know that you, we both had friends who were working that show, and I know that would possibly be a deciding force, but if you find out about a different show in an area that you haven't been to, what's going to be one of the deciding factors for you as far as picking that show in pro wrestling?
Do they got good concessions? Are there going to be hot chicks on the card? Are they hot shotting it, and do I have this person's autograph?
Okay, so you're looking at all different aspects, whether it be from the overall person, the customer service aspect of it, as well as the name factor of it, to the familiarity factor of it, then, right?
No, dude, I'm just looking at it for myself, man. If you got crappy concessions,
Well, how do you know if they got crappy concessions if you haven't been there before?
Well, I'm going to go, like I said, you know, I'm going to see if they got crappy concessions, you know, be like, what's up? You got a corn dog? No, you ain't got a corn dog? Kiss my butt. I want corn dogs. I'm going to write a review. I'm going to trash you. Why? You don't have corn dogs. Do they have hot chicks on the cards with big fake boobies? You know, if they do, yay me. I'm going to go. You know, but hey, do they have somebody half decent, you know, that they probably overpaid to book because they're trying to make, you know, their name, and it's probably going to, you know, sink them 2 or 3 months down the line? But hey, screw that. Am I going to get an autograph or a picture or whatever? Am I going to schmooze with somebody I like? Yeah, you know what? Hey, I'm going to do it. Why? Because I am an asshole.
Now, Mr. Kennedy, or Anderson, or whatever the hell last name he's using.
No, got that from Dennis Leary.
Dennis Leary. Yeah, but I started.
Yeah, I mean, that's why. Now, I mean, seriously, though, if you really want, like, from a business aspect, you know, for Beyond Ringside, you know, and go report back and, hey, blah, 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 oh. One, are you running in a crap town building? Like, seriously? You know, or in somebody's backyard? You know, if you're in a backyard or, you know, something like that, then no, I'm not going to show up. If half the guys on the card have pudding bellies and wrestling jean shorts and get blown up walking to the ring, I'm probably not going to, you know, not going to go. If I've heard, you know, utter just BS, you know, not BS, but just like, just, you know, just poop about your company from guys who are in the business who I know and trust, no, I'm not going to show up. You know, why would I want to go sit there and spend the money that I could have watching porn on demand? You know, why would I want to sit there and watch you and your fat buddy roll around in your blue jean shorts after you just got through cutting Uncle Fester's yard for $20? Screw that noise.
See, therein lies the funny part, because you lead me to another good question that I'm actually going to jump ahead of myself with. Now, and I get this into both of you. When it comes to a new show, when it comes to a new promotion, and you hear about the names that are going to be on the event, how much time do you actually take? Now, I'm knowing the fact that, once again, Mabo, been with Beyond Ringside, leans to the journalistic side of complete and total perversion, as well as, you know, approaches the business from a pure standpoint. Same thing for Vicky, not necessarily the perverted side. However, she does look at it from a business standpoint as a reporter and a journalist, as well as a fan, as, from that vantage point. When you see the show advertisement and you hear of a couple of names that you're not familiar with, do you actually take the time to look them up, per se, on the web and try to find out a little bit more information about them before you make up your mind as to whether or not you're going to go? And Vicky, I'll start with you.
No, I don't. I honestly don't. I plan on going to the show in Phoenix City. And why? Because I want to see what they got out there. I want to see what they're doing. I want to see what kind of show they're putting out. You know, if they got Timbuktu Bubba and his brother up there fighting in the octagon, well, by Johnny's, I want to see if they're any count. So, will I look them up? No. Will I go to the show? Yeah, because I want to see what kind of fighters they got over there.
Hey, Bo, same question. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Well, Vicky, you ought to be ashamed of yourself for not doing your journalistic duties. You ought to be ashamed of yourself. Go run your head into the brick wall until the birdies show up, all right? Shame on you. You should do your research. if you're putting together a ranking system, do your research.
No.
Do your research.
I don't eat, Mabo.
I drink a milkshake.
Stop.
You have a milkshake.
Mabo.
And I have a milkshake. And I have a straw.
And both of you.
Which is all the way over to your milkshake.
And both of your milkshakes bring all the boys to the yard, okay?
And I drink
it's
all.
Mine.
I drink
it's
it.
Mine.
I drink all. Drink all.
Welcome back, Mabo.
I drink it up.
Continue.
Now, actually, as opposed to what Vicky does, which is, you know, probably sticks a stay-at-home picture nose and then goes, hey, we got to go to the event. I actually, if I've not heard of these guys, I do my research. How do I do that, you ask? Well, thank you for asking. One, I hop on this wonderful thing called the Internet. If they're not a big enough name to have made at least some kind of indentation on the World Wide Web, then I probably don't really give a crap. Two, as you know, Eddie, I have, you know, several friends who are in the business, and I'm, you know, especially on the local scene.
Oh, maybe three, one or two.
Huh?
Oh, maybe one or two.
One or two, possibly three, with a mohawk who looks damn sexy in a speedo of leopard print.
Oh,
and I sit there and I go, hey, you know, have you heard of this guy? Have you seen him? What do you know about him? Is he good? Is he, you know? And I go based on their opinions. And if, you know, if they give fairly, you know, fair, you know, reviews of the gentleman or lady in question, I'm like, well, you know, let's go check him out. And, but then again, also, you're going to realize I'm only going to the show if there's names that I really know of. Now, if, you know, if I know or heard of or would like to see wrestlers X, Y, and Z, and I also see on the undercard wrestlers A, B, and C, I'm going to go, hey, you know, what do you know about A, B, and C? Oh, they're good? All right, well, you know, I'll definitely give them, you know, I'll keep my eye out. I'm not going to go just specifically to check them out. But when, you know, when they're doing their, you know, what they're paid to do on the undercard, I'll definitely be like, oh, okay, cool. All right, well, you know, they were right about this, or they were wrong about this, or this, this, and this. And that's how it goes. And that's how you do your job, Vicky!
Vicky, you're more than welcome to go to Mabo's place and spank him. He'll thank you for it later.
I severely doubt that. No. I doubt that.
You fib. Well, folks, no. Tell you what, I'm going to take it 5 minutes before the top of the hour, and I'm going to go ahead and turn it to last call at this point, and I'm going to open up the floor to both Vicky and to Mark and give them the time to run with any particular subject that they'd like to do, whether it be ask a question, whether it be just lay out a point of view, perspective, shameless plugs, immediately thereafter. And tell you what, because I know Mabo goes in 9 different directions at one time, Vicky, I'm going to put you on the spot for last call, unless you'd like to defer.
Oh, no, I'll never defer. Okay, shameless plug number one. There's a new sponsor that they didn't mention that Strike Club's going to have next weekend at the Strike Club show. It's Martial Arts Life Apparel. They do a lot of stuff in Mississippi. They're doing Alan Belcher's T-shirts for his training camp, and they do they sponsor Charlie Rader and a bunch of different fighters. They're actually going to be setting up a booth at the Strike Card show, and they're going to be selling T-shirts and fight shorts and all that good kind of stuff. So they'll be new to the Tuscaloosa area. This is their first little jaunt into Alabama. So everybody go out and buy them a male T-shirt, because they're just great that way. You'll love them. And if I could have one other shameless plug to say, this is for all of my lovely, wonderful MMA fighters in the state. Go ahead and get your blood work done. Go ahead and make sure you have a government-issued picture ID that you present to the person when you weigh them in.
God, yes.
And when you show up to weigh-ins, please weigh what you're supposed to weigh and not be 15 pounds over. I love you. I really do. I love all my fighters, but go ahead and get your blood work done. It takes at least 3 days to get the results back, and we all hate waiting for the last minute. So go pick you up a male shirt at Strike Hard, and if you plan on fighting in the next few months in Alabama, and if you're a fighter, you probably will, because we have so many shows that are coming up and things that are going on, go get your blood work done, make sure you have a government-issued picture ID, and show up to weigh-ins weighing what you're supposed to weigh.
Okie dokie.
That's all.
And where can everybody track you down on the web, Vic?
On the web, I try to Twitter and tweet at NNAVicky, V-I-C-K-Y-J. On Twitter, on Facebook, it's Vicky Jackson, V-I-C-K-Y Jackson. I also do local MMA online Alabama, so look for our local MMA online Alabama Facebook page, and that's about where you'll find me at.
Mark Mabo Bowman, last call.
Ah! Hold on, I'm stretching. Give me a minute. Okay. Sorry, I like to stretch.
I worry about you.
I'm like a large jungle cat. I must stretch before I pounce. Ha ha! Anyway, last call. You brought it up earlier in the show, Edwardian, and I'm definitely going to say it is so good to have, as much as I love Alex Shelley, and if you know, I have very few man crushes in this world. CM Punk's one of them. Tunsy's another.
Wicked Nemesis.
Wicked Nemesis. Not so much a man crush, more like a man one night stand.
It's a bromance.
Yeah. In a mutual admiration for each other's areas. Anyway, as much as I love Alex Shelley, and I do love Alex Shelley, he's awesome, it's even better to see him back with Chris Sabin and the Motor City Machine Guns, back in TNA, back on television, back both healthy. You know, I was looking for it, and Taz even pointed it out on the broadcast. When Sabin entered the ring, when he was jumping, when he was, you know, moving around on his knee, of course, I'm not sure what word Taz was trying to use. I think he was going for wincing. I think Taz called it rancing or something like that. I don't know. Taz speaks his own language.
Yes, he does.
Yes, he does. He looked phenomenal. Sabin looked 100%. The guns had, you know, no ring rust on Sabin. No ring rust on the guns, period. You know, it's still as fluid as ever. Don't want to spoil it, because, you know, we discussed spoilers earlier. But for those who have read it, you know the situation that's, as Eddie would say, that's going to be in play with them coming up. Do I think that's too soon? Honestly, yes. I think it's too soon. Should have built them up a little bit more. But regardless, I'm just happy to see the Motor City Machine Guns back, revitalizing TNA's impact. Are they Did they ever decide if they're going to be TNA or Impact?
Impact.
Yeah, but why do they still have TNA? I mean,
it's TNA Wrestling, but it's Impact is the show.
No, I know that, but I mean, weren't they going to try to call themselves Impact Wrestling at one point?
I don't know. I gave up on trying to figure them out.
Yeah. Anyway, whatever this company's called, to revitalize and re-energize the tag team division, because let's face it, the majority of the tag teams that are there right now, I mean, now that Inc. is gone by the wayside, you don't really, and Beer Money has crumbled, or I guess gone flat and cashed out.
They paid their tab.
What?
They paid their tab.
There you go. Wow, you actually said something intelligent and semi-funny this show. Good on you.
I did my research.
Oh, see, he did his research. There you go. Take notes, Vicky. But regardless, you know, hopefully they will bring in more tag teams, and this will be the, and no pun intended, this will be the genesis of the tag team division in TNA. And just please, God, don't separate them and put them in freaking in the X division against each other. As awesome as that is, please don't do that. And also, you know, Eddie, I don't really give a crap about, you know, I watch Raw, I watch SmackDown already, and Ring of Honor, but I haven't really ever been able to find, you know, links for FCW, mainly because I really didn't go looking for them. But I have been watching this past episodes that you emailed me, that was on the YouTubes, and it was very good, very good. Got to see Tyler Black, a.k.a. Seth Rollins. Saw Dean Ambrose cut a phenomenal promo, and I could just see him cutting that on somebody in the WWE, probably CM Punk, especially after what he said. So, you know, definitely check out. If you have access to watch Florida Championship Wrestling, watch it, because that's the future of WWE right there. That's the future. And one other point, and Eddie, you might have caught this. I know I tweeted it. In his ever so eloquent way of saying on Raw this past week, Johnny Laurinaitis sat there and told CM Punk, basically, you're not just going to be in for your dark days, you're also going to be in for a natural disaster. Well, if anybody knows Japanese or speaks Japanese, like I don't, they do know that the name Tensai translates into disaster. I thought it was just a comment on what the gimmick was, just a complete disaster. But
pretty much.
It's probably going to be, that's probably who Punk's going to be feuding with once he and Jericho's feud go by the wayside.
Okay.
There you go.
Shameless plugs.
Shameless plugs. You can locate me on the Twitter at MA_BO. You can find me on the Facebook. Just look at the screen. Right there on the Facebook. At Mark Merriman.
Actually, it is on the screen.
See? I told you. You can also find me, although unless you play DC Universe Online or WWE 12, that's the only way we're going to be able to communicate to each other. I'm on the PSN or the PlayStation Network under MA_BO. I would really like for people to play the DC Universe Online with me. We could be superheroes or supervillains and have powers and defeat evil or right wrongs or cause chaos. Also, I'm sure Eddie's going to throw the graphic up in a minute. These are some of the things that I enjoy, and you should enjoy them too.
Already up there.
That would be, first of all, BevNerd. You can find him on Twitter at BevNerd. Also, BevNerd.com. Also, BevNerd on Facebook. He just posted a video, Wired Waffles. You heard me, Sunshine. I guess they're energy waffles. I don't know. It just seems rather ridiculous, if you ask me. But anyway, go support him. Also, Eyewitness Store. I believe they're on the Facebook and possibly the Twitter and other such things. That's the letter I, did witness, like you must get rid of whenever you commit a heinous crime, store.com. Also, check out Bob's Comics. I don't have his card in front of me because I'm taking a dump.
Oh, thanks.
This has nothing to do with Bob's, because Bob's Comics is phenomenal. And if you want to read upon the Avengers versus X-Men, which is the new hot storyline going on, check that out. He also has thousands of back issues, and toys and collectibles, and he smokes, and so it's kind of stinky in there. But I love Bob anyway. Is I don't really know if the card's still up, Eddie. What else? What else do I?
Sky Pilot.
Yes, Sky Pilot Project. Yes, and other things and such. There was one more that I was supposed to mention, and I can't remember it.
You know, one we haven't mentioned for a while is Gimmicks Tees.
Yes, Yolanda, who was at WrestleMania.
We haven't had her on for a while. We may have to set this up.
Yeah, we'll discuss that later, Eddie.
Okie dokie, sounds like a definite plan. Throwing the world in my direction, folks. First off, I want to say thank you to David Elder for coming on with us and letting us know about the Strike Hard production. Strike Hard 15 coming up on April 14th in Tuscaloosa at the Killer Buzz Arena. Looking forward to hearing a lot of great things. Vicky, I want to thank you for taking the time to come on with us this evening. We were originally scheduled to have Spider Boudreaux, the winner of the Carnage Cup, up last weekend in Elk.
Spider.
Yeah, I know. Why, if you say it like that, why do I feel the inane urge to go back and pick up the Zorak tone from Space Ghost?
I don't know, but that used to be a He-Man figure. Spider!
I like Space Ghost better. Okay, we'll move on.
Yeah, do that long enough. I bet you won't be doing any karaoke later on this week.
Probably the hell not. Although, for those who do like to sing in the Birmingham metropolitan area, come join me on three great nights. Wednesday nights at Papa Science in Helena, the old In Cahoots building. Thursday nights, Buffalo Wild Wings in Hoover, Alabama, at the Promenade. And on Friday nights, Buffalo Wild Wings in Alabaster. Start time 10 o'clock at the Friday night show in Alabaster at the Promenade Shopping Center. First off, Global Championship Wrestling, my brethren and sisters, with GCW will be returning to action on Friday night, April 13th at the Locust Fork High School in Locust Fork, Alabama. And back on Saturday night in Jasper, Alabama at the A&E Fun Center. Two great shows. Pro wrestling fans, definitely check them out. Wicked Nemesis, of course, is going to be a part of the Pro South show on Friday night in Piedmont, Alabama, 627 Southern Avenue. And he will also be on the Peach State Wrestling Alliance show in Carrollton, Georgia on Saturday night, April the 14th. Mabo, we're going to have to get you out to some of these shows, dude.
Yeah, pay the gas and I'll go.
There you go. I think, well, we almost arranged that. Be careful. We can arrange that. And we will be returning to our regularly scheduled time next Sunday night, coming back at 6:30 Eastern, 5:30 Central. Please take the time, drop over facebook.com/beyondringsidelive. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter. You can see the Twitter feeds for myself, as well as some of the other cast here at Beyond Ringside. Myself, Wicked Nemesis, Mark Mabo Bowman, Paulie Wells, Brooks Logan, all have Twitter feeds available. Just follow us. Like I say, you can see the different addresses up on the screen. And we, of course, don't forget that all episodes and interviews are available for download for free through the podcast store in iTunes. We broadcast live every Sunday night, normally 5:30 p.m. Central. Because of Easter, we bumped it back a little bit, give everybody a little bit more time to recuperate from family gatherings and everything else they were dealing with over the weekend.
Not me, buddy. I had to squirt, so I didn't go. I didn't want to get my family sick.
There you go. See, just when you think you know exactly what Bowman's going to say next, he will throw the curveball. We've had some great...
Hey, can you smell this?
No, I don't.
I just pulled something out of my belly button. I don't know what it is, but good God. It's a piece of breading from a chicken wing. How'd they get my belly button?
We've had some great interviews here on Beyond Ringside in recent days. Thank you again to Bobby Gunn, the Celtic Warrior, for coming on. I've not gotten the official update from what happened last night in Clear Haven, Mississippi.
Probably got the crap beat out of him.
So, former NWA, excuse me, current four-time NWA World Heavyweight Champion Scrap Iron Adam Pearce joining us in recent days here on the show. As well as the Angel of Death, John Rare, having joined us in recent days. Thank you to everybody who... Kevin Brannon, the owner of IWA Deep South, joining us in recent days as well. All those interviews are very much available through our podcast site, and you can also catch the links for all of the recent interviews and episodes, especially at our Facebook fan page. Once again, that is facebook.com/beyondringsidelive. Now, for
and coming soon... Hold on!
Yes. I was about to hit
coming
the...
soon! To the Beyond Ringside Network. Can I get some dramatic music here?
Okay, that's as close
interviews to interviews from the 2012 IWA Deep South Carnage Cup featuring the crazy albino polar bear man John Rare and some guy that's named after John Mathis, Johnny Mathis, Tommy, Ronnie Mathis, Ron Mathis.
Okay, the, Matheson, the, I think is his last name.
Mathis? No, it was Mathis. It was Mathis.
Okay.
I think his name was Ron. Well, there was John Rare. And then there was the big scary polar bear man. What was his name? Oh, fudge. What
Freak Show?
No, he took on Bill the Butcher.
You know that better than I do. I was not there. I had a prior commitment that
I day. Know, and I feel bad because you're supposed to friend him on the Facebook.
Ah. Name? See, did not he know was, that I was no, did not know that I was supposed to friend him on Facebook. I didn't get that memo.
Well, we haven't, I haven't sent you the interview yet. We haven't arranged for the meeting.
There you go.
Crazy Cody Krueger.
Ah, there you go.
I knew the name was slightly racist.
It had nothing to do with Mathis.
No, Ron Mathis was the other gentleman. Relentless Ron Mathis, John Rare, and Crazy Cody Krueger.
You sound like the guy who was a manager over at PCW for a while. What was that, Oscar Worthy?
Oh, I miss Oscar Worthy so much. It was the best interview ever.
For
my
him.
Nipples were erect with excitement. And Eddie, are you ready for this?
Yes.
I haven't figured it out.
Hurry.
But I'm going to do it tomorrow. Quite possibly we're going to have a live recorded in front of a studio audience musings by Mabo on a webcam.
Nice.
I just don't know how to freak to figure it out.
It's easy. I'll show you how to later.
Okay.
Because for the reason why I'm cutting you off is because in about 48 minutes from right now, wrestling fans inside the state of Alabama and the southeastern U.S., I will be co-hosting GCW Radio. Check out facebook.com/GCW Pro Wrestling. That show goes live at 9 p.m. Central, 10 o'clock Eastern. The rest of the time zones are on their own. Now.
But why don't we just talk all the way to win?
No. I have post-production to do.
No. We could talk in fair British accents.
No, because I would be doing Australian.
Can I call in and do a fair British accent?
Yes, you can.
And I could call myself Nigel.
Okay, you can do that.
Can I really do that?
You've been hitting the hemorrhoid medicine again, haven't you?
I'm telling you, my butthole is swollen shut. It looks like the arse of an atom.
Okay, and line.
I'm pretty sure we lost Vicky. What? 30 minutes ago,
she's
40
still,
minutes ago.
She's probably still picking her jaw up off the ground from some of the comments that you've been hitting.
Well, let's go ahead and put a ref on this puppet.
Folks, we're going to be back at it next Sunday night, 5:30 p.m. Central Time. Tell your friends, thank you for being a part of the broadcast. Everybody over in the chat room, I saw Daryl be over there in a few minutes ago. Always great to see you. Chris, I saw you pop in a few minutes ago.
And there was somebody named Ragdoll.
Yes, what Ragdoll was in there a little bit earlier. Good to see her in there as well.
Wait, that's a female?
Yes, Ragdoll was a female. Thanks for playing. And I know who it is.
Oh.
Yes, I know who it is. However,
I'm
not breaking kayfabe on this one. Thanks for playing. The fourth wall will stay intact. But
no, you're a douchebag. Go ahead.
Well, let's see. That's probably one of the nicer things that I've been called in recent days, so I'll just go ahead and leave it at that.
But well, later on tonight, join Fast Eddie Lane. And I believe you're having Mr. Hagen with you tonight.
Yes.
Join Fast Eddie Lane and Mr. Hagen as a co-host. What's your little show called?
GCW.
The World Championship Wrestling, GCW Pro, on the Ustream and the other networks. Possibly, probably not, because we're going to make a quesadilla. Possibly joined by Sir Nigel.
God. Let's take it home. For... I'm going to kill you. For Strike Hard Productions promoter David Elder, thank you. Spider Boudreaux, wish we could have caught up with you. There will be another time. For tag team partners, Paulie Wells, Brooks Logan, the Oracle of Ominous, the Wicked Nemesis, for MMA reporter, our favorite Southern Belle, Vicky Jackson. Say bye, Vicky.
I'm still here. Bye, y'all.
For Mark Mabo Bowman, who's lost his frickin' mind.
I would like to say, hush, Vicky, do not make me come over there and smite thee. First of all, I'd like to say and wish everyone a happy Easter. I wish I could have spent it with my family, but I had a case of diarrhea.
So, to my mommy and my meemaw and the rest of my family, happy Easter, and I will definitely see you guys for my cousin's graduation birthday later on in a couple of months.
There you go. This is the Magic City Motor Mouth Fast Teddy Lane saying, I need medication after this last half hour. Adios, das vidanya, hasta luego, auf wiedersehen, ciao, sayonara, adieu, whatever, darn cheap, farewell, abasinya, au revoir, and until we meet again, aloha means bye-bye. And we'll see you next Sunday, 5:30 Central, 6:30 Eastern, right here on Beyond Ringside. Bye for now.
Hello, it's
right. Bowman, you're a crackhead.
I would like both of you to know, as I was raised in South Wales, I was but a young lad, and I had my scrotum shorn at a very young age, and it was smooth like the Easter eggs the children hunt today.
Vicky, go spank him, please.
I do not
he was liking too much.
He probably paid
him. I need nothing from you, trollop.
He'd probably pay you.
I do not pay for the company of women. I earn it.
Easter eggs done well, bye-bye.